ban on same-sex marriages as unconstitutional. Judge Rex Burleson called the freedom to marry a fundamental right deeply rooted in the history of the United States. The news comes a day after a federal judge ruled a similar ban in Kansas was in violation of the Constitution. On Monday, a district judge threw out an alleged 1993 confession from Daniel Villegas, the Texas man who spent 19 years behind bars for a murder he did not commit. The district judge stated that the confession could not be used as evidence in an upcoming retrial because it was coerced by police. Support for Liberty Beat comes from Midas Resources Incorporated, helping clients convert their paper 401ks and IRAs to solid gold and silver. Get their 10 Reasons book free by calling 800-686-2237. That's 800-686-2237. Support also comes from Sovereign Living.
The American Psychiatric Association has issued an alarming study warning that the nation's used car salesmen are going completely insane, and in some extreme cases, practically giving cars away. The APA traces the outbreak of widespread hysteria to an apparent overstock of high-quality late-model cars begging to be driven off the lot today. Some severe symptoms include delusions, manic exuberance, and a psychotic commitment to offer the lowest prices guaranteed. Families are joining together to raise awareness of this serious psychological epidemic.
The authorities found out how unbelievably low his prices were. They'd lock him up and throw away the key.
You are not alone. Over half of America's used car salesmen are currently going bonkers.
Car dealers suffering from this condition are prone to project their own disorders onto others. According to Mad Max, the Car Czar's website, you're out of your mind if you're not taking advantage of these low, low prices.
This is the Onion News Network.
This is Free Talk Live. We invite you to take control of the airwaves toll-free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Oh, you can join us online over at freetalklive.com, and you can enjoy the features there. You get to create the content. What you see there on the front page was created by listeners just like you, and you can vote up what you like and down what you don't. That is how it works. It is Reddit-based, and it is totally free. So go to freetalklive.com to get interactive there. With you in the studio tonight, you've got Ian.
Ellen.
And Daryl.
So, of course, we'll take your calls about anything. And still to come, the latest on the widening crackdown on the black market websites. We talked to last night in detail about the Silk Road, Silk Road 2.0, being targeted and taken out by the feds just yesterday. And it turns out they weren't the only site. I've got an update on that story. Plus, Daryl, you'll be telling us about a 90-year-old man, I believe it is.
90-year-old man.
Who is illegally feeding the homeless and has now been arrested for it more than once. We'll share that story with you as well. Toll-free number tonight, 855-450-FREE. We've also got Skype. You can Skype into the show at username lrn.fm. We've got Dan first, though, in California. Dan, you're on Free Talk Live. Go ahead. Dan in California, going once. Dan.
Hello?
Hey,
hello?
You're on the air.
Okay, great. Hey, how you doing?
Good. Go ahead.
So I was listening to you guys yesterday. You were talking about PGP and man-in-the-middle attacks, and I decided I had to call in and clarify the situation.
Okay, great. Whatever you're going to say as digestible for a general audience as possible.
Right, yeah. It's a little bit complicated, but not really. So here's the thing. Your understanding from yesterday was that if I'm keeping my private keys private and you're keeping your private keys private, I have your public key, you have my public key, our computers are not compromised, then we have a secure connection. That was what I understand that you were saying yesterday.
It was a conversation we were having about PGP, which is pretty good privacy, and Daryl was expressing some concern about having heard something about what's called a man-in-the-middle attack, where somebody essentially sits in between you and the target that you're trying to send or receive information from and pretends to be that person or at least
I'll send the information through Ian's website to you, Dan. And as it's been explained to me, and hopefully you can tell me if this is just a load of bull or not, is that what Ian gives me is purported to be your public key, And what Ian gives you is purported to be mine, but both of those are actually his. And so he's receiving all of the info and compromising it in the middle.
So that's exactly what I called in to say, but that's not what you were saying yesterday. So I thought that you missed that point.
Yeah, that's not what I heard being said yesterday. So if I misunderstood
you. I don't think that I mentioned that point, but if you send something through a third party, that they can, in mm-hmm. theory, compromise the security by using some sort of encryption thing and lying to you about it.
Right. So the important thing is, so you don't, for something really serious, you don't trust the encryption of the website that you're talking to. If you really want to be secure, in principle, what you want to do, if I'm talking to Ian, is I want to meet him in person and get his public key, and he gets my public key, then it doesn't matter what third party we're talking through, nobody can crack it.
I mean, right, but that's not practical when you're talking about people from different parts of the world doing business with one another.
That's right. So, I mean, I don't know that there's much. Well, there are some things you can do. You guys were saying that your public key is kind of out there on the site. If your public key is published all over the internet, it's plausible, but it's a lot more difficult for that to be spoofed. Like a famous person could have their public key all over the internet, and it's just a lot less practical to spoof it in that way. There's things you can do, but
before you go on, so what has been said today? I didn't understand Daryl was saying last night. And so let me try to restate what's going on here. And Ellen, if you're lost at all in this conversation, please let us know, because I don't want to talk over somebody's head. So PGP requires that that you have a public and a private key, and you publish the public key to whomever it is you want to be able to send you things that are encrypted. You keep the private key private. You don't want to give that to anybody at all. And what we were talking about last night, what you've described now, Daryl, makes more sense what you're saying. You're saying that your concern would be that someone could masquerade as though they're Ian Freeman, send you their public key claiming to be Ian Freeman, and then you thinking that was Ian Freeman would encrypt that message with that other person's public key, meaning they would be able to read the message you had intended for Ian Freeman. Is that what you're getting at, Daryl?
That's not exactly how the monkey in the middle sort of thing was described to me. Mm-hmm. The way it was described to me was anytime you send through a third party, mm-hmm. whether it be an email service like Gmail or a website like Silk Road, you're sending it through a third person.
Right.
So what the guy from the tech panel at Keenvention told me was you shouldn't trust encryption because there could always be a monkey in the middle to where somebody tells you that it's one thing, but it's actually something else, and then they wind up taking whatever info.
Right. Isn't that what I just said? I mean, that they would be masquerading as you, essentially, right? So they would be intercepting your mail that you were sending. Let's say I was sending you the public key. Okay?
Right.
They intercept my email and they modify it to have their public key in it instead. That way, when you encrypt the message, I wouldn't be able to actually read it. Only they, the hacker person, would be able to read it once they received whatever message you were sending. Is that what you're getting at? Am I miscommunicating still?
I think that might be it, but so this leads to the question of should encryption at all be trusted because everything is going through a third party provider.
What do you think,
of
Dan?
Some sort?
Okay, so just to clarify what's going on here, you're both sort of right. The thing is, what Daryl is describing applies specifically to exchanging of public keys. If, like I said, you were to meet in person ahead of time, which I understand is not practical oftentimes, but if you're just sending emails, for instance, you're sending emails to your friends, you can very easily meet them in person, in principle.
Well, you could also verify a public key by being on the phone with somebody.
Yeah, sure. That's another way. Yeah, there's things like that. But the point is, once the authenticity of the public keys are established, then you can safely go through any third-party medium.
That's correct.
But
so if you know, Daryl, if you know you've got my public key, you encrypt something with that public key, you can send it through any third party you want to and they can't read it without having my private key.
Okay.
Is that clear?
So the only reason that I should trust encryption is if I'm able to talk to you in person to get the private key.
If you're not certain that whoever has sent you a public key is the person who they represent themselves to be, then you need to verify it. So if I send you an email and I say, Daryl, this is my public key, and there's a chance that that didn't actually come from me, that, you know, that it actually came from somebody else who is masquerading as me, then you would want to do some sort of verification on
okay,
that.
But if you're buying substances from Silk Road, mm-hmm. you're not going to be able to call up the drug dealer in Colombia to verify his public key.
What is
that's this? Right.
Yeah, okay. So what's the concern is what exactly? That the federal government would have been the agency that would be essentially receiving your encrypted messages in that case?
Well, I don't know if that's it or not. I'm just asking because, you know, somebody that supposedly knows stuff about encryption tells me not to trust encryption if you're sending through a third party. Mm-hmm. And now you're saying verify by speaking to the person.
Well, right. The only thing is, look, when if you were on the Silk Road, which is an underground black market website,
was
and you buy, you know, you want to buy some sort of illegal drug from someone, and they require that you send them an encrypted message in order to do that, you're sending someone a message somewhere in the world. Maybe that is a federal agent that's actually collecting information of people who wanted to purchase drugs. That's certainly a possibility. But there's no one else who, you know, is going to be able to read that. It's only the person who's operating that public-private key pair, whoever that person is. So besides the concern that it would be some sort of federal information grab, I don't know what the concern is there. Because even still, anybody who buys on the Silk Road or another underground market like that can put whatever address they want in there. So just the fact that someone received an address attached to an order of drugs isn't enough to connect the person who is at that address with actually placing that order, if that makes any sense, because it's anonymous. You don't know who put the address in there, and you don't know who's receiving at that address either. There's more coming up here. Dan, thanks for your call tonight. It's Free Talk Live, 855-450-FREE.
DVD, books, music, instruments, periodicals, computers, software, electronics, photo, cell phone, office products, home and garden, bed and bath, furniture, kitchen, pet supplies, automotive, hardware, apparel, shoes, jewelry, grocery, healthcare, sports and outdoors, toys, games, used and more. It's a department store at your fingertips. Shop.freetalklive.com. Get all your shopping done, get a great deal, and a portion of your purchase goes to benefit Free Talk Live when you enter Amazon via shop.freetalklive.com.
Are you searching for your soulmate? Someone you can trust, who will never betray you or cooperate with the NSA? Stop searching. With EasyDNS, you found a keeper. EasyDNS does it all. Domain names, web hosting, and managed WordPress hosting. EasyDNS stands up for your internet freedom. And with servers in Canada, they do not cooperate with the NSA. Go to EasyDNS.com. You'll love their services or get a full refund. They guarantee it. And they accept Bitcoin. That's EasyDNS.com.
Gold isn't for you? Ted Anderson, president of Midas Resources, one of the world's premier gold and precious metal investing firms. I get it. You wouldn't buy gold if you believed that the government is doing a great job, that the Fed will stop handing out trillions of dollars like bailout candy, that Social Security would be there for you. That's not what's happening. You might even pass on gold if the stimulus package wouldn't fuel inflation, or that the dollar wouldn't lose value, or that your retirement would be secure. If all looks rosy to you, then now is not the time to buy gold. For the realist, there have never been more sobering reasons to diversify with gold. Since 2001, the U.S. dollar index has tanked 30% while gold has risen 300%. Right now, savvy investors are adding gold to their portfolios. You should too. Find out what they know. Call us and I'll send you 10 reasons why gold will do very well, free. 800-686-2237. 800-686-2237. That's 800-686-2237.
Because we are smothering in spam, please do not reply to all when you can instead reply. I was recently among over 100 invited to a corporate reunion. It's always a warm affair, and that's the problem. Enthusiasm for our upcoming get-together caused many recipients to RSVP the organizer with a cheery reply to all. I can't wait. Then others piled on with a reply to all to that. Then the I'm out of my office now autoresponders joined in. So I replied to all, asking that we all reply only to the organizer. Hey, at least I tried. One invitee, apparently retired, shot back, point taken, but I really like seeing the responses since they're so positive. Smiley face. This better be an open bar. from SurvivalSpeech.com. I'm Holland Cook.
Did you know that you can listen to and watch Free Talk Live during our live show 7 days a week from 7 to 10 p.m. Eastern via our studio cam at cam.freetalklive.com? Not only that, but you can also chat with other listeners at the same time. Do I need to mention that both the studio cam and chat room are totally free? Outside of Free Talk Live's live hours, you won't see a cam feed, but we'll hear audio from the Liberty Radio Network. So listen, watch, and chat all free at cam.freetalklive.com. That's cam.freetalklive.com.
Are you a political activist who does things that the government might not like? Then this free ebook may save your life. Rats is your guide to protecting yourself against snitches, informers, informants, agents provocateur, narcs, finks, and similar vermin. Rats was written by OG libertarian Claire Wolf. Rats is a short book, easy to read, and available free in many formats. Download Rats free at rats-nosnitch.com. That's rats-nosnitch.com.
Help get LRN.FM into more ears. Visit promote.lrn.fm for a free bumper sticker, flyers, banners, graphics, and more. Promote.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live, dial toll-free, 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. You can join us online over at freetalklive.com and enjoy the features we share with you there. Once again, that's Free Talk Live. .com. We have started out talking tonight about security on the internet. So now there's steps that you can take to be more secure, but it's important to remember nothing's perfect. There's always something that can go wrong. There's something that can fail. There's something you can forget to do. There's nothing's perfect. No security protocol is completely uncrackable. And usually the weakest link is the humans involved, as we found out last night with the Silk Road 2.0 takedown. From the beginning of Silk Road 2.0, there was an undercover agent who was one of the trusted administrators of the website. So it doesn't matter if you've got rock-solid security encryption between you and the undercover agent, because then they're decrypting all the things you're saying to them, and they're an undercover agent, so they're saving all of it in a file to use against you later. So in that case, you know, you could have felt as though you trusted that person, and then turns out they were using, you know, their level of trust to put you in a prison cell. So you never really know. And that's probably the most, that's probably the weakest spot of any kind of security system is the staff, is the people. Like, you know, when you're at a business, frequently the people that are stealing from you are your own employees because, you know, they know the ins and the outs and the back end of how things are working. There was a lady here in Keene, New Hampshire, who had her own assistant. Her personal assistant was embezzling big money from her business, allegedly.
Like $250,000, right?
Yeah, something like that, $200,000 worth. So, you know, it's hard to pick the right people to trust. And if you've got the wrong people to trust, then all of your encryption is for naught. So keep that in mind. But there are still tools that can be used to improve your safety online. And there are certain things that are being done to you that are almost a guarantee unless you do something about it. And one of those things is your internet service provider logging every website you visit and every search term you enter. They're likely doing that, and they may be keeping those logs for 5 years in some cases. So one of the ways to stop that level of encroachment on your privacy is to get ProXPN, and you can do that for free. Start out by going to proxpn.com/FTL. You can sign up there and, again, get started with Windows, Macintosh, iOS devices, and Android devices, plus Linux users. It's pretty easy to get you set up as well. It's just a bit of a different process. Go and get started at proxpn.com/FTL. When you're ready to upgrade to their premium account, you'll get unlimited bandwidth, servers around the world that you can access. You can privately torrent and get past regionally blocked websites. By using code FTL50, you'll get 50% off of that annual account, and that's good for the lifetime. That discount, it's good for the lifetime of your account. Plus, you can save even more, 62%, by using code FTLBTC and then paying with Bitcoin for the annual account. So again, proxpn.com/FTL. You get some great benefits. It's a risk-free 7-day money-back guarantee, and they don't keep records of your online habits at all. So use those promo codes, FTL50 or FTLBTC, and get a great discount on privacy that is priceless. We continue here. Your calls and thoughts. Welcome. Think Fish is on the line in Atlanta. You're on Free Talk Live with Ian, Ellen, and Daryl.
Good evening, guys.
Hi there.
Good to talk to you.
Go ahead, sir.
The other night,
I don't get to listen at night. I usually listen to y'all on the podcast on my way to work in the morning. And you and I don't remember who was co-hosting with you. He was the guy that organized the 420 rally.
That would have been Rich Paul.
Rich, well, you guys were talking, and I believe it was you, Ian, that made the statement that you don't consider voting and running for office activism.
Not what I said.
Okay,
what
I said was, I may have been mistaken.
Yeah, what I said was I don't consider voting to be activism. Running for office is definitely activism.
Right, and to a degree, I think that voting is, in and of itself, that 420 rally, and admittedly, I don't know that much about it, but any rally, it's a good way to inform and educate, but in and of itself, I mean, when it's over, what do you have? A shortage of Doritos and Keen.
Well, no, what we had was international press coverage. We had great video footage. We had a memorable, epic activist occasion, plenty of great pictures. So there's much more that came out of that than some people eating some munchies.
Yeah, activism is more about changing people's mind and drawing attention to your viewpoint. It's not, you know, just going out there and doing something that's illegal.
Well, the definition of activism...
I understand that. Yeah. But what I'm saying is, yes, you inform people, you educate them, you change their minds. But if they don't go to the polls and back the people that are like-minded and running for office, it doesn't do you any good. Voting is a form of activism. You have to have the people to back the people that are like-minded to me.
Look, I'll give it to you that by definition... it probably would qualify as activism in that you are trying to affect society by voting. If you're voting, you know, not for the lesser of two evils, and you're actually voting for somebody who does actually, you know, hold your viewpoint as much as possible. But it's the most weak form of activism. It's the most least committal. I wouldn't call someone an activist because they went out and voted. That's sort of the thing that is expected of Americans, is that they go and vote. And I don't think that if you're doing something that's not above and beyond what's expected as a citizen or whatever,
your civic duty.
Yeah. Again, I don't think it's anyone's duty. I'm not saying that. I'm just saying that it's expected by people.
Right, it's expected. And the reason that I made the civic duty joke is because That's the lie that you're told. Like, it's your civic duty. It's expected of you to go do X, even though only half of the people wind up going to vote anyway.
Well, I see his point, though, because whoever gets elected into a position of, having authority or office, they do affect changes. You know, they control things that will eventually affect your life in some way.
It's true. And I think that activists should vote. I mean, I like what Rich Paul was saying earlier on the show, where he pointed out that, look, he wants the people who vote to come out and support him at the 420 celebration. He's willing to go out and vote to support the people that are doing the political thing. And, like, you know, we should scratch each other's back as activists. And if there's an activist who loves liberty who's running for political office, then it should be an activist should go and participate in that vote. But that doesn't mean that I'm going to call every little old lady and person who walks into the polling location an activist. I just don't think that qualifies to me as activism, because it's not above and beyond the norm. It's not unusual.
I would say calling your representatives and members of Congress, writing them letters,
that's more
activist. Going to testify, exactly. Those are things that definitely qualify in my book.
Yes, I agree with that.
Well, and I do have a problem with something, not what you said, but I agree with what you said, but I have a problem with people that go and vote and, well, I'm just going to pick the lesser of two evils. You're not doing anything. If you're not voting your heart and what you believe in and what you fight for, to me, that's you're doing the wrong thing. You're doing it for the wrong reasons.
Yeah, I totally agree there.
If you believe in something, and you should do everything you can to get if you want change, and this is one problem I have, is that I'm a very impatient person, and the problem is change takes time. You're not going to get it overnight.
Boy, tell me about it. Good call tonight, Think Fish. I'm with you, man. Thanks for the call, except for the fact that, you know, the claim that it's activism. I agreed with everything else he said. You don't qualify to me as an activist because you went out to vote. So you've got to do something more, anything more. Right. Than voting. 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. That guy handing, you know, holding the signs and handing out flyers out in front of the voting location, that guy's an activist. People walking by and just punching a Chad, nah, not so much. 855-450-FREE. It's Free Talk Live.
With autumn in the air, it's time to think about getting ready for winter. And it's time to save at herbalhealer.com. You'll find amazing seasonal savings to prepare you for the fight against cold and flu season. Like oregacillin to promote lung health. 30 capsules, regularly $34.95, now only $25. HHA olive leaf, a natural antiviral, normally $16.95, now 60 capsules are just $12. HHA elderberry power, a great flu and virus fighter, regularly $16.95, 60 capsules, now $10. Save on all our homeopathic detoxes. Choose from lungs, kidney, liver, brain, libido, or whole body, normally $26.95, now just $20. Visit herbalhealer.com and click on the Fall Winter Specials button to save on all our natural cold and flu fighting products. Also, explore our Herbal Healer Academy correspondence courses that teach you how to handle your health naturally. HerbalHealer.com, healing the world with nature, one person at a time, since 1988.
Free Talk Live.
The heavy-handed language that you're speaking out against the government is, I never heard anything like this on the radio.
When the founding fathers decided that the government of England was no longer servicing their needs, they stopped paying their taxes first.
Don't you drive on roads? Aren't you glad you're defended from the foreigners?
Sir,
the foreigners are coming to get me.
These aren't foreigners I need to be defended from. It's these people down the street calling themselves government that are willing to steal my property from me and burn my house to the ground, which
it
is what they did to this man.
It's not yours. The government owns it.
Really? Are you telling me, sir, that every one of us are actually serfs? We're actually subjects and slaves to the state? Is that what you're telling me?
Well, if it sounds good to you...
No, that doesn't sound good. I don't accept it. I'm a free man.
Free Talk Live, 7 nights a week from 7 to 10 Eastern, live on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
If you want to move to the free state... you're looking for some real estate. Well, I know a guy who's really great. It's the realtor Mark Warden. Do you want a home with 20 acres, a lakeside cabin, any takers for renters, buyers, and sellers too? Mark Warden is the guy for you. PorcupineRealEstate.com.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. You likely buy all kinds of things online. Amazon is the largest online retailer. You can get what you need at the same prices with free Super Saver shipping by going to shop.freetalklive.com. Please do your online shopping at shop.freetalklive.com.
Attention! Have you been in a serious automobile accident? Then you need to call our attorneys now. We specialize in helping our clients get compensated for major auto injuries. If you've been in any type of car or motorcycle accident and you've been seriously injured, you may be entitled to significant financial compensation. Our attorneys have recovered millions and millions of dollars for injured clients. There are no out-of-pocket costs to you ever. We only receive a fee when we win your case. We are available 24/7. If you've been in an accident and been seriously injured, make this free call to our attorneys now. Call the Personal Injury Center at 800-648-9173. 800-648-9173. 800-648-9173. That's 800-648-9173. This ad is paid for by participating member law firms. We are not an attorney referral service. Representation may not be...
This is the Liberty Radio Network, broadcasting the latest liberty-oriented audio content 24 hours a day at LRN.FM.
This is Free Talk Live. You can dial in toll-free and bring up anything you want. 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Already tonight, callers bringing topics to the table that we weren't necessarily prepared for. PGP, encryption, security, and also what is activism? How do you define what activism is, and is voting activism? These are things we've already discussed. Still to come, the 90-year-old man and associates who were arrested for...
This guy's definitely an activist.
Yes, absolutely. For giving out food to people, to hungry people.
Yes.
Apparently that's illegal in some places. We've covered stories like this in the past, and the crackdown is still continuing. Now it's Fort Myers, Florida, where the...
Fort Lauderdale.
Fort Lauderdale. There's a lot of forts down there. Fort Lauderdale, where they are cracking down on folks feeding the homeless. We'll give you that story coming up here. Your calls are also welcome at 855-450-FREE, plus the latest on the what is appears to be a major crackdown on the online drug markets, much larger in scope than we first believed yesterday when we did the show. We'll continue with your calls and thoughts. Also, you can go to freedomsphoenix.com to uncover the secrets and expose the lies. That's what they get every day, the readers over at freedomsphoenix.com. And you could be one of them. Just go to freedomsphoenix.com. You can sign up for their free daily dispatch or just read the website. They've got all kinds of real news that lies between the lines of propaganda and the relationship we have with coercive governments. freedomsphoenix.com offers up-to-the-minute updates on the economy, technology, communications, and the rise of the police state. That's freedomsphoenix.com. Kenzo is listening in Atlantic City. Kenzo, you're on Free Talk Live with Ian, Ellen, and Daryl.
Yeah, hi. I don't want to really pick on this show because I've noticed this is the case with other shows that are similar to yours that, you know, talk about liberty topics and truth issues. And I was just wondering, I mean, why do you and these others advertise for people to invest in precious metals like gold and silver if you understand that the central banks are actually the ones that are behind this? And it's an amazing...
But the central banks are behind what?
Well, they're the largest. They're the ones who are selling it. They're the ones who...
That's not who I buy from. I buy mine from Midas Resources.
Okay, but I'm just saying, where do they get it from?
Well, they have different vendors and different sources. Who cares where they get it from? What matters is whether or not you have the gold or the silver in your possession.
Well, actually, it's more than that, because you see, the people who actually set the price, and basically Midas is a broker, is the banks. The central bank set the price for gold and silver.
It sounds like a conspiracy theory to me.
Well, I mean, it's all right. Well,
I mean, you're talking about a global marketplace for products. You're talking about a global marketplace. There's a lot of factors that go into play as to whether or not gold or silver, what the price is. Look, I'll give you one thing, that there are banks out there who sell gold and silver. I'm putting quotes around those, gold and silver, where they'll give you a certificate and they'll claim to have gold and silver in some kind of vault somewhere, and that you could collect it if you want to.
Hey, that's how fractional reserve banking started.
Yeah. I understand. You're talking about instruments. I'm not talking about that. I'm talking about actually owning physical gold and silver. The price of the world market is set by the banks, namely the Bank of England.
Well, it could
that's
be
a conspiracy theory, right?
It could be argued that because manipulation of the... Hold on. We're talking over one another.
Okay. Go ahead, please. Sorry.
It could be argued that, you know, because central banks manipulate the amount of currency in circulation, that they set the price of everything. So that can of Campbell's chicken noodle soup
that
I bought to fight off the Ebola, you know, the price of that chicken noodle soup was in some way set by the central bank because of inflation. The price that I paid for the antifreeze and the windshield washer fluid earlier today, that price, in a roundabout way, because of, you know, currency levels and inflation, the price of that was set by the central bank. Is that what you're getting at? Or are you saying that, you know, Janet Yellen and some group of people at the IMF sit down every day and write down the price, and then they control every transaction of gold and silver? Is that what you're saying? Or are you saying that it's because of monetary policy?
No, what I'm saying is, however you want to ascribe what it is that leads to those particular prices. If you understand that the people who own the most are the ones that set the price, because they're the ones who are buying and selling.
Okay, so Campbell's
that, and you,
Campbell's owns the most chicken noodle soup, so they set the price. You know, that's how things work. Like, whoever is doing the most transacting gets to sway the price.
But at the same time, hold on a second. If I buy, the price is set by buyers and sellers all around the globe. If I whatever the price of gold is or silver is what it is at the moment I make the deal. And, you know, I offer a certain amount, they accept a certain amount or vice versa, and we agree and we come to a deal. And that's the price of gold and silver, whatever it is in that moment, in that exact transaction. I mean, to say that
right.
there's...
It is arbitrage, and that's where the problem comes in, is because it's being sold to people in a massive advertising PR campaign that the dollar is going to collapse. Who's doing that? The central banks. And this is the solution. And the question you have to ask
Wow,
yourself,
you are... This is a fascinating conspiracy theory. So thank you for the call, Kenzo. I appreciate hearing from you tonight. So just to recap what he said there. So...
I find it kind of strange because I know there's people buying and selling all over the world, especially in Africa, where most of it's being mined. Mm. And there's not really central banks that control that. It's mostly just local vendors or people who are purifying it and then reselling it on the market.
But behind the scenes.
So what he's saying, the conspiracy theory he just posited, was that the central banks... The ones that are manipulating the money supply with the dollar and these other central fiat currencies around the world, that the central banks are printing a bunch of money. They know this money system is going to crash and burn someday. That's what happens to all fiat dollars.
So they're trying to speed it up.
Well, what they want to know, what the claim is that they're at the same time selling gold and silver to people so they can make even more money, because they're selling gold and silver on the, you know, the pitch that the money system's going to collapse, and so more people will buy gold and silver. He's suggesting that the money system's collapse, or what some people believe is an imminent collapse, I don't know if I agree with that, but the, you know, the money system's collapse is a sales technique for the central banks to sell gold and silver. Is that what you heard, Daryl?
That's exactly what I heard.
That's ridiculous.
When I've gone to the U.S. Mint website, and I've gone there a couple mm-hmm. times to look at some of the silver products that they have, they way jack up the price, like drastically. I can get stuff a lot cheaper going through Midas or one of the other companies that sells silver.
Well, but then his conspiracy is that Midas and all the other companies that are selling them are ultimately buying them from the central banks, which I don't...
Well, it's not like the central bank owns all of the gold in the world, or that they control even a vast portion. I mean...
Well, he was suggesting they do. And I don't know, honestly, how much gold and silver the central banks control. Some would say they have far, far less than they claim to have, that Fort Knox has no gold in it.
Right.
That kind
why
of thing.
Why would they have interest in keeping it anymore? It's not like they need it for anything.
Exactly. They can just print out as much money as they want to. So, yeah, why should they keep it? And, in fact, it's interesting when you look at these banks that will sell. Now, this isn't a conspiracy theory from what I understand. Some banks will sell you gold and silver on paper. And then you can exchange that paper, these warehouse notes, basically, for that gold and silver. Well, the stories that were coming out over the last few years, and I haven't heard one in a little while, but that doesn't mean it's not happening. The stories were that people who had gold and silver on paper had tried to contact the bank to say, all right, I want my real gold now. I want to collect my real gold. And the bank's response were like, whoa, we're going to work on that for you. It'll take us a little while. And it took them a long time to actually fulfill the order. And the idea was that it's taking them a long time, like weeks and weeks and weeks, to fulfill these orders because they don't have the gold and the silver on hand. And they've got to wait until they gather enough of it together to where they can actually fulfill the orders. So they have been, that the allegation is that the banks have been selling gold and silver that they don't have on paper, on the hopes that people won't actually try to collect the physical product. Now that's dishonest, and if that's going on, it's a terrible thing, because that does to some extent affect the price of gold and silver, but over time gold and silver have historically been good checks against inflation. There's more coming up here, 855-450-FREE.
Here's a good idea. When you have a legal matter like creating your will or legally setting up a business with a corporation or LLC, you don't necessarily need a law firm. Use LegalZoom.com. At LegalZoom.com, you answer straightforward questions online and they take care of the rest. They even review your answers for common mistakes and guarantee your satisfaction. Free Talk Live listeners, you'll get 10% off your order by typing in FTL in the referral box at purchase. Don't procrastinate with these important legal documents. LegalZoom.com.
Majid lives in Nordevin, Armenia with his wife, kids, and grandkids, all in the same house.
They have cows, but to compete against the big ranchers, Majid needed to get a loan for more cattle. Free Talk Live helped him get a loan for the cows. He bought them, and now he's very happy with the expansion of his farm. You can help us help more people by getting your coffee through coffee.freetalklive.com. Make a difference, one cup at a time. Get a free pound to try out the subscription. Cancel at any time. coffee.freetalklive.com.
The experts at web.com want to build your business a successful website for free, just like we did for these current web.com customers.
We've used and looked at other website designers, but there's nobody better than web.com.
Web.com can build your website in as little as 7 days free. Plus, we'll promote it on all the major search engines like Google, Yahoo, and Bing. If after 30 days you're happy, we'll continue to provide promotion, hosting, support, and maintenance, all for one low monthly fee. If not, cancel and pay nothing.
If you're in business today and you don't have a web presence, you won't be taken seriously.
Call right now and you'll also get a free .com or .net domain name for your new website powered by VeriSign, the world's leading domain name provider.
Call 800-297-0154. That's 800-297-0154.
No upfront charge for site build, after which ongoing fees apply. Rights to site are relinquished when canceled. Domain included during active service, after which fees apply.
That's 800-297-0154.
Free Press Publications is an independent, alternative media and publishing company founded in June 2009 with the mission of ensuring a free press for the freedom movement and is committed to spreading the message of peace, freedom, love, and liberty. FPP also gives new authors an avenue for publishing freedom-oriented material. FPP brings you daily news and commentary on the website fpp.cc, as well as a daily 5-minute newscast, FPP Radio News, and weekly news, views, and commentary in the FPP Freedom Minute and Peace, Love, Liberty Radio at fppradio.com, and the monthly newspaper FPP News at news.fpp.cc. Find FPP online at fpp.cc. That's fpp.cc, as in Creative Commons.
If you want to know the latest about Free Talk Live before we go on the air, all you need to decide is how you want it delivered. It's your choice. Visit news.freetalklive.com. You can get emailed announcements and participate in contests via our email updates list. Plus, we have a Twitter account that you can follow and a Facebook page where you can become a fan. So visit news.freetalklive.com to get news about Free Talk Live as soon as it's announced and the way you want it delivered at news.freetalklive.com. That's news.freetalklive.com.
Are you tired of governments murdering people around the world? Stop using their money. There is an alternative. Bitcoin is a stateless, free market, non-political currency. Bitcoin cannot be inflated or controlled by any government. By using their money, you are helping the state. Stop doing it. You have an incredible alternative available now. Learn it. Use it. Spread it. Get started with Bitcoin at weusecoins.com. That's weusecoins.com.
You can sign up to receive the latest about the Liberty Radio Network via our email updates at updates.lrn.fm. That's updates.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live. Dial in toll-free here. 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. The latest on the global crackdown on darknet domains like Silk Road 2.0. That's still to come here tonight. Plus, a 90-year-old man arrested for feeding the homeless. Daryl has that story. You are welcome to comment here toll-free at 855-450-FREE. And, you know, since our last caller mentioned it, you can get your gold and silver from gold.freetalklive.com. You go there, you get some amazing gold and silver pieces at great prices, and customer service, they're great too. Midas has been at this for a long time. The toll-free number is 877-857-9938. That's 877-857-9938. And it's important to point out that, you know, even if what that last caller was saying is true, and I don't believe it for a moment, that the gold and silver price is ultimately controlled by the central banks of the world,
Even if that is true, then over time, if you look at the price of gold and silver, it does compete, or it does keep you up against, it keeps you up with inflation, meaning that if you have gold and silver over the years, you know, you don't pay attention to the ups and downs every day or every week or whatever, but you compare like back 100 years ago, you know, how much gasoline you could buy for an ounce of silver versus how much gasoline you can buy for an ounce of silver today. And it's very similar. Like, you know, a good suit of clothes might have cost you an ounce of silver 100 years ago, and a good suit of clothes would cost you an ounce of silver today. I'm making very general statements. Obviously, there are exceptions to this. Like, you can point out that, you know, clothing technology has gotten better. Clothes are made cheaper now, so you can probably get a good suit of clothes for a little less than an ounce of silver. But my point is generally that looking at the price of gold and silver over time compared to inflation, it does tend to keep people up with protecting them from inflation of the money supply, because that's just how gold and silver have worked. Is that a guarantee that's going to do that in the future? No. Past performance is not a guarantee of, you know, future performance, obviously. But, you know, there's something to be said for hundreds of years of history. So keep that in mind. Go, and if you're ready to get gold and silver, if you want to get some more, go to silver.freetalklive.com or gold.freetalklive.com, or call them, Midas Resources, toll free, 877-857-9938. Or you can subscribe to some sort of ridiculous conspiracy theory, and I don't know, what are you going to invest in then? Like, if not gold and
dirt
silver.
Dirt and chairs.
Yeah, I mean, cigarettes, maybe? Do those go bad over time? I guess it would, right? Tobacco would go bad over time.
Yeah,
right?
It does eventually. If you keep it long enough, it'll get moldy or just dry out.
But what's the shelf life? Like, 5, 10 years?
Don't ask me. I'm sure it's a decent amount. And
you're the smoker in the room.
Well, a cigarette.
She doesn't keep them
thing.
That long.
Okay.
No, I don't. But I know that some cigars are finely aged, mm-hmm. so that could be, you know, that could depend on how you store it.
If you keep them in a humidor, then they should stay for a while.
The let's see. Also, you could get some alcohol, right? Like hard liquor. That stays good for a little while, doesn't it?
Yeah. Doesn't that stay good forever?
Yeah.
And
some
then
have been aging for 30
wine,
years or more.
If stored properly, will get better with age.
Right, right. So,
up
you
until
know,
the peak year.
I suppose you could buy some other stuff. But the nice thing about gold and silver is it's easier to store than packs of cigarettes and toilet paper and things like that. And you know, you can store more of it in a small space, and it'll be worth more typically over time. Anyway, 855-450-FREE is the toll-free number here. That's 855-450-3733. I suppose you can either invest into some alternatives, or you can trust the fiat currency. I mean, what are the people who believe in that conspiracy theory do as their alternative? I guess we should have asked him that.
Like, just buy lots of fiat currency?
Toilet paper, sense. Bottled water, you know, stuff to make shotgun shells for when the zombie apocalypse happens.
Well, there's nothing wrong with having toilet paper and bottled water and gold and silver. So our toll-free number tonight is 855-450-FREE. So there's a 90-year-old gentleman in Fort Lauderdale, and apparently he's teamed up with a group of folks who've been feeding some homeless people. It's not just the 90-year-old man who's been arrested, apparently, but he's the one who's getting the headlines because...
Right, because he's 90 years old.
Right, and whenever an elderly person is arrested in an activist way, it's just more newsworthy. Normally, it's people in their early 20s or 30s who will get arrested at some sort of protest for locking arms or handcuffing themselves to
right,
a gate.
Because they're young radicals who have no idea what they're doing.
But when it's an elderly person, then it's a news story because, for whatever reason, old people just don't do activism for
the
most part.
He's off his rocker. I'm sure people say that.
That's probably true. Like, he needs to be under some sort of care. But to me, I think that this guy's a hero, and I wish there were more people like him. What did he do?
So, 90-year-old Arnold Abbott was arrested for feeding homeless people in Fort Lauderdale, Florida. That was on Tuesday. He got arrested again on Wednesday. He has helped prepare hundreds of meals a week for countless hungry homeless people in Fort Lauderdale since 1990. So he's been at this for 24 years. But a new ordinance now makes it illegal in the city. As a result, Abbott and two ministers from the Sanctuary Church were arrested while dishing out hot food Tuesday night. Then they have a couple of photos, and I have to scroll down past those.
Photos of the criminals in act?
the criminals in action, and actually a couple of shots of the criminals being handcuffed by other criminals that had little shiny badges. And they have a really nice setup here. They've got several folding tables, and they've got the large metal dishes with the aluminum foil on top.
If you've been doing something for two decades, you probably got it together. You know, yeah, you probably have tweaked it.
Repeat offenders. I mean, they've obviously got it all down, the process.
So, you know, it looks like it's one of these things of if you go to a large potluck gathering to where people bring those disposable aluminum dishes covered in aluminum foil. In the one photo, I see one, two, three, about seven dishes next to one another.
Sounds
and
like
everybody
eating.
Is like dishing out a couple of things and handing the plate to the homeless people.
Maybe the cops are just hungry. They wanted to steal the food.
Says that, however,
the evidence.
That, however, is not stopping them, and they were back at it again Wednesday night as if nothing had happened at all.
That's awesome.
And after they finished serving food, police again arrested Abbott.
Well, at least they waited till afterwards.
It seems that despite Abbott's amazing charitable ways, the mayor of the city, Jack Seiler, has nothing but disgust for the selfless old man. Seiler told Local 10 News, Mr. Abbott has decided that he doesn't think these individuals should have to have any interaction with government, that they should be fed in the parks. We disagree.
They should be fed in specific places, even though they're probably short on food most of the time and don't get that option very often.
This mayor is actually saying that these homeless people should get their food from the government.
Yes.
Well, it's quite disgusting, really, because most cities now have this, like, I don't want to say a war necessarily, but they're very opposed to homeless people.
Yeah, that's absolutely the case.
Yeah, and I've seen a lot of things like this occurring throughout the years, more recently so, just trying to, you know, discourage people from interacting with homeless people, trying to get rid of them, ship them to other cities or other areas, or put them in jail for something.
This was going on in Sarasota, Florida, where I'm from originally. Right before I made the move up here, there was a one of these ordinances that was passed where I think it was within a certain 2-mile radius or something like that, or all of the downtown parks or something, was prohibiting the feeding of any group larger than a certain amount at any time in these locations. And then in Orlando, there was news headlines where Food Not Bombs was setting up and getting arrested just like this, where they'd come back out and they'd feed homeless people again, and then they'd get more arrests and more people would step up, and it was just this crazy situation. And it's, you're right, it's happening in more places where these government guys will ban homeless people from being fed within a certain area around the city. It's okay in some places to feed them, but you just can't be near City Hall. Or in some places, they're just straight up banned outright in the entire city limits.
Well, first of all, like, are you going to be asking somebody, like, hey, can I see the title to your house before you feed them? And, like, second of all...
Well, the laws are written to where you just can't feed anyone in a park. I mean, it would they're not so much... It's resulting in picking on the homeless, but if you were to have, like, a church picnic in the park, that would also be against the rules.
There was a... And, Ellen, I'll let you get to your thing in just a second.
Okay.
I remember reading a story back in the spring to where there was a guy down in Birmingham, Alabama, where I'm from. He's the minister of a church. He has a food truck, and the only thing that was done from the food truck was food was given to homeless people.
For free?
For free.
Mm-hmm.
The city council had passed some kind of ordinance saying that food trucks required licensing and all of these other health code things.
You got to protect people.
And
Darryl.
He said, well, I'm not selling food. I shouldn't be required to get this permit. And they said, no,
it
applies
food.
To any food being given out of any truck.
Yep. What happened?
I'll have to check on that.
Toll-free number tonight, 855-450-FREE. There's more to this story, right?
Yes.
With the old guy, 90 years old, arrested for handing out food to the homeless. Could be happening where you live, too. 855-450-FREE. What would you do about it? It's Free Talk Live.
When Karl Marx failed because the workers of the world did not unite, that was the end of communism.
Not a chance. It went underground and attacked the culture. Movies, the school system, the family unit, and Christian values. Cultural Marxism, featuring Ron Paul, Pat Buchanan, G. Edward Griffin, and Ted Baer, explains what happened. Get the DVD at moviepubs.net, worldnetdaily.com, or newswithviews.com.
Lumber Liquidators, America's largest specialty flooring store, is using our buying power to offer great deals on over 230 hardwood and laminate floors just in time for the holidays. Get pre-finished 3/4-inch solid maple for $159 a square foot. That's more than half off other stores. Save up to 43% on our thickest and best laminates. Plus, attach padding at no extra cost. And get other incredible flooring deals, plus 18-month special financing. Get to your local store. These deals are going on now. Visit LumberLiquidators.com to find a store near you.
Liberty activists around the country are starting to realize politics alone won't set us free. So what will? At Liberty on the Rocks, we believe the answer starts with living your principles, spreading ideas, and connecting with those around you. By starting a Liberty on the Rocks network, you can make a difference by uniting libertarian thinkers. Find out how much fun it is to build your local network from the ground up. Visit libertyontherocks.org today to get started.
Here's a chance to do a little activism while you're cruising Facebook, Twitter, or Google+. Between the LOL cats, the recipes, the hot girls, and the inspirational sunrise memes, Free Talk Live's post pass by your newsfeed. Like them. Comment. It gives us more exposure. If you don't see our posts, click like at facebook.freetalklive.com and then hover over it to click get notifications. It's an easy way to spread the ideas of liberty a bit further. I know you're busy, but you can spare that tenth of a calorie it takes to click on something. facebook.freetalklive.com.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number two is next, after the news, here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
From Canaan, the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Friday, November 7th, 2014. Silver is trading at $15.46 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,148 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $346. Antiwar.com reports, as they do every time the issue of U.S.-Iranian relations comes up, the White House has insisted that their policy is unchanged. The statement was dubious yesterday, however. That's because a report out of the Wall Street Journal said that President Obama had last month sent a secret letter to Iranian Grand Ayatollah Ali Khamenei. The White House declined to discuss what was termed a private correspondence, but the report is that the letter primarily focused on American and Iran's mutual war against the Islamic State. Officials have denied any direct coordination between the U.S. and Iran, who are both active in Iraq. Whatever the contents of the letter, however, the fact that a letter was sent at all proves that U.S. policy is anything but unchanged. FPP Radio News is brought to you by Roberts & Roberts Brokerage. For over 35 years, Roberts & Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They now take Bitcoin for purchasing precious metals so you can turn your profits into a long-term investment. Call Roberts & Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing. 800-874-9760. A joint press release from the FBI, Department of Justice, and Homeland Security says that Blake Benthal, aka DEFCON, was arrested in connection with his operation and ownership of Silk Road 2.0 website, a hidden website designed to enable its users to buy and sell illegal drugs and other unlawful goods and services anonymously and beyond the reach of law enforcement. Manhattan U.S. Attorney Preet Bharara said, as alleged, Blake Benthal attempted to resurrect Silk Road, a secret website that law enforcement seized last year by running Silk Road 2.0, a nearly identical criminal enterprise. Bharara added, let's be clear, this Silk Road, in whatever form, is a road to prison. Those looking to follow in the footsteps of alleged cyber criminals should understand that we will return as many times as necessary to shut down noxious online criminal bazaars. We don't get tired.
According to the complaint unsealed yesterday in Manhattan federal court, since about December 2013, Benthal has secretly owned and operated an underground website known as Silk Road 2.0, one of the most extensive, sophisticated, and widely used criminal marketplaces on the internet today. The website has operated on the Tor network, a special network of computers on the internet distributed around the world, designed to conceal the true IP addresses of its computers on the network and thereby the identities of the network's users. As of September 2014, Silk Road 2.0 was generating sales of at least approximately $8 million per month and had approximately 150,000 active users. FPP Radio News is brought to you by Coinbase. Coinbase is a simple and secure online Bitcoin wallet for sending, receiving, and storing Bitcoin. Get started at coinbase.fppradio.com. That's coinbase.fppradio.com. Reuters reports a federal appeals court on Thursday bucked a recent trend of pro-same-sex marriage decisions by upholding state bans or restrictions in Kentucky, Michigan, Ohio, and Tennessee, pressuring the U.S. Supreme Court to take up the issue. The 2-1 ruling by the Cincinnati-based Sixth Circuit U.S. Court of Appeals is the first ruling by a federal appeals court that upholds bans on same-sex marriage. The High Court, if it agrees to hear the case, could potentially issue a decision by the end of June, saying once and for all whether any states can ban same-sex marriage. In Thursday's ruling, the appeals court upheld same-sex marriage bans in Kentucky and Michigan. It also ruled that Ohio, Tennessee, and Kentucky are not required to recognize same-sex marriages that take place in other states. Judge Jeffrey Sutton, appointed by Republican President George W. Bush, wrote the majority decision and said plaintiffs favoring same-sex marriage had not made the case why courts should intervene instead of leaving the matter to state legislatures. He wrote, "When the courts do not let people resolve new social issues like this one, they perpetuate the idea that the heroes in these change events are judges and lawyers," adding that he believes it is preferable that courts defer to the customary political processes in which the people become the heroes of their own stories. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
Could dropping bombs on Afghans without warning from terrifying robot airplanes that fly themselves actually hurt America's efforts to stabilize Afghanistan?
It's complicated.
No, not at all. Actually, I think we need to stay the course. You don't change horses midstream, and you don't stop firing missiles from unseen death droids soaring high above the clouds just because a couple of schools get blown up.
We have got to find another way to obliterate this population.
What about flaming bulldozers or 50-foot tall tanks?
Let's do what we can for these civilians. I mean, why not name the drones Billy or Steve to make them seem less dispassionate?
Oh, that is a terrible idea. Billy is a horrible name for a drone.
They're now developing a 40-foot robot that actually looks more like an American soldier and also sprays lasers out of his eyes.
Well, at least that's a step forward.
Hey, look, as long as it fires missiles and bombs with very little accuracy and zero Americans are at threat, I'm all for it.
Good point.
They should give it funny, floppy arms.
Yes.
Oh, it should spray candy out of its chest a few minutes before it starts shooting everything.
This is the Onion News Network.
Free Talk Live. You are invited here to take control of the airwaves at 855-450-FREE. Maybe you are someone who believes that homeless people need to be starving to death in the streets, or that the government needs to be the one who's feeding the homeless, because that's what some people apparently believe. Daryl's got this story about a 90-year-old man who has now been arrested at least twice.
At least twice.
For feeding the homeless in Fort Lauderdale, Florida. And I've got kind of a rundown here from the Daily Mail. They did a video report. You earlier were reading from the Daily Mail, and you'll continue that here in a moment, along with some comments from some people who support the crackdown on people who are feeding the homeless, which I just find to be so twisted.
The comments are actually on a different story about what was happening in Birmingham, Alabama, and I had mentioned that. And just to sort of summarize that real quick, there was a food truck ordinance that went into effect at the beginning of this year. There was a preacher that had food truck in Birmingham, Alabama, had a food truck that he was giving food out of the truck. Didn't charge anybody any money.
That's awesome.
He had a Bible verse written on the side that said, "When I was hungry, you gave me food. When I was naked, you gave me clothes." The city decided, well, nope, the food truck ordinance applies to everybody, even if you're giving food away. He was prevented from giving food away on one of the Saturdays. It does not say if he was arrested, so I'm going to assume that he was not. But he went ahead, you know, tried to do it, was prevented, and then came to some sort of agreement with a local church in downtown Birmingham that's near the park to begin giving out the meals from that church instead of out of his truck. So, and so some of the comments were in response to that situation.
Okay. Yeah, well, you know, if you allow people to be giving out food for free, how is that regulated? How are we not sure that they're being poisoned? Rather, let people starve to death and let the government serve them certified safe food.
Well, because nobody who is in the kitchen of a restaurant could ever poison food. Because the government went there once a year and did an inspection.
Right. Nobody's ever gotten food poisoned from a restaurant. Nobody has ever gotten sick from beef that was sold at a supermarket, causing the FDA or USDA to then issue a recall for 300,000 pounds of beef. That never happens.
Well, I know that in this story, we got two stories going here, but in the original story about Fort Lauderdale, there's comments from the mayor.
Yes.
And his comments are very revealing about what this is really about. Because while what you're saying, Ellen, is a common excuse for government regulation of food trucks and restaurants and things like that, this story is really just about the fact that the government wants to be the one in control of where homeless people get their food. And ultimately, that's what the mayor is all butthurt about. Because it makes him look bad. If you go out there with your church group or your Food Not Bombs group or whoever, and you start feeding the homeless and you do a better job than the government does at it, you show them up. And
right.
And if the government can be shown up, then they lose their legitimacy. If people can't count on them and instead, you know, they're counting on a private organization like a church in this case, then that ruins their aura of legitimacy, and that's one of the worst things you can do to the state.
So should I reread the comments from the mayor of Fort Lauderdale?
Yeah, go ahead and reread those comments, and then maybe share some of the Facebook comments as well that are from Birmingham, where people are taking the side of the city.
So the mayor of Fort Lauderdale, Jack Seiler, says, Mr. Abbott has decided that he doesn't think these individuals should have any interaction with government, that they should be fed in the parks. We disagree.
We'll show him. That's just the thing. You don't just disagree with the mayor. When the mayor disagrees with you, he sends men with guns to take you and put you in a cage when you disagree. Because, well, as I think it was Mark Stevens who pointed out in the past, law is just an opinion backed by a gun.
Yeah.
That's what we're talking about
here. So some of the comments from the situation in Birmingham: if I can't have a business because of health codes, if I can't sell it, you can't give it away. You can't have it both ways.
Ah, so the old slave-on-slave violence example, where someone has already been through the rigmarole and the difficulty and the ridiculous fees and obedience process that is getting a license, and so they feel like, well, everybody needs to have a license. Everybody
needs
to be abused.
Well, then we can't do any charitable things anymore. We can't do anything for free because there's always somebody out there that's going to want to make money off of it.
Right. Another comment says, good, I'll support this ordinance and hope it stops the church groups and makes these bums go somewhere else. It's a great idea for Birmingham. But not everybody is, you know, anti-homeless.
Stop the church groups. How dare they feed people?
There's three comments here that sort of, you know, uplift my spirit a little bit. The first says, I'm still going to give to the needy no matter what. That's why the Birmingham population is going down. Officials have less concern for the citizens, plus high taxes, corruption, etc. The second one says, I'm sorry, I will still go to the homeless, or rather, I will still give the homeless food or money. Give me a ticket. Throw me in jail. Jesus helped the poor. He helped the people that were down. It's not for me to judge what the homeless do with their resources. It's what we're supposed to do.
You know,
greed is the worst, and greed has obviously taken over this city.
Even if you don't care for homeless people, even if you are kind of like anti-homeless and you want to clean up the streets and get them off the streets. And I can understand. I mean, homeless people don't tend to smell very good and they don't dress well and they're not necessarily a draw, right? Like if there's a lot of homeless people in your downtown area, that may keep people away from shopping. And I get it. I get that. But if the homeless people are hungry, they might be more likely to stick a knife in somebody to like take their wallet or something, you know,
right.
So
and
at least...
That's a good thing to consider just as a safety precaution is that you want to keep everyone happy and safe.
And
but,
full, right?
Like yeah, but full. I mean, it's more about the humanity of the situation and, you know, being considering that somebody is somebody's in need, somebody needs help, somebody's hungry. And, you know, if there's somebody out there, maybe not you specifically, but somebody's willing to help them, then why would you not allow them to?
It's a sick hatred, really. And then some people have this. Mark used to be very hateful towards homeless people, and he's changed on that perspective. He used to say some very nasty things about homeless people on this program years ago, and now he's an active contributor to the local privately run homeless shelter.
Yay!
Which I think is a wonderful turnaround. So people can change.
That's a total 360.
Yeah, even if they are, you know, nasty in the beginning towards homeless people. Because look, I get that. That's a good point.
Well, he said turnaround, so I was thinking.
Which would
right 360? You would be facing the same direction.
Okay.
Technically, that is a turnaround as well.
If he goes back to hating homeless people, then it'll be a 360.
Yes.
So
until then, 180.
Look, I understand some homeless people. They're homeless by choice.
Right.
That is true. And if you're homeless by choice, then you know I don't really feel so bad for you. And there's also the homeless people who are homeless by them continuing the fact of their choosing drugs over, oh, I don't know, paying for a place to sleep.
Right.
So there's certainly people who are homeless by their own actions, but there are also people who are homeless by, you know, things that happen to them, like their house caught on fire, or, you know, they, for whatever reason, they got fired from their job and they didn't have enough in savings to pay the rent, so they got kicked out of their house. So, I mean, there are always different stories out there. Which ones are true? I don't know. I don't really care so much about, you know, vetting everybody who picks up a sandwich from a homeless food outreach thing. I can understand the desire to give to the people who really are the needy, as opposed to the ones who are like abusers and users.
Right, right.
I can understand and appreciate that, but at the same time, you know, how much effort do you really want to put into vetting somebody before you give them a bologna sandwich or something? I mean, is it really worth it to sit them down for a counseling session?
No.
For that? No. No, it's really
show
not.
Show me the title to your house.
Yeah. So, I mean, I can understand the objections. And in which case, if you don't want to support feeding the homeless, then don't support feeding the homeless. But why can't you, as was pointed out earlier, why can't you just allow it to happen? Sit back. Ignore it. Go play golf or whatever it is that you do where you don't have to see homeless people around, right? Because the golf course probably is fenced and they're probably not going to let the homeless people wander around on the golf course to bother you while you're playing golf. You go play your golf while the people who want to feed the homeless, and everybody can get what they want. Just stop trying to control other people. 855-450-FREE. Otherwise, you get 90-year-old men in handcuffs and video footage of that getting out and going viral online. We'll play a little bit more from this here in moments and tell you about what happened. Your comments are welcome. It's Free Talk Live.
Here's a special message for those of you who owe the IRS at least $10,000 or more in back taxes. The IRS has special programs in place that could eliminate or reduce your tax debt by thousands of dollars. Call the tax helpline that has been set up to help you. 800-691-6129. That's 800-691-6129. Stop the wage garnishments, levies, and tax liens now. Once you've qualified and enrolled, the IRS will stop all the collection activities against you. These unique programs have been allocated to help the economy and significantly reduce or eliminate your tax burden. The IRS is currently accepting reduced settlements and other favorable programs. You may qualify for substantial savings, so get the help you need. For free information and to see if you qualify, take down the number now for the Tax Representation Hotline. 800-691-6129. That's 800-691-6129. 800-691-6129.
On the average, Americans work between 45 to 50 years, hoping to build up enough wealth to retire and live out their golden years. Unfortunately, with taxation, the rising cost of food, energy, housing, and medical, many retirees are forced to live below the poverty line. Is this a flaw for the enterprise, or is our monetary unit we call the Federal Reserve Note forcing us into perpetual debt, ensuring inflation and higher taxes? These questions and more can be answered by reading G. Edward Griffin's book, The Creature from Jekyll Island. Congressman Ron Paul states it's what every American needs to know about central bank power, a gripping adventure into the secret world of international banking cartel. Hi, this is Ted Anderson. I will give a silver dollar from the early 1900s to anyone who purchases this book. Call 1-800-686-2237 and order a copy today. It's critical that the public be made aware of the system. Call and order your copy today at 1-800-686-2237. That's 1-800-686-2237.
On Free Talk Live, we're bringing people to the ideas of liberty every day. From wrestling superstars like Glenn Jacobs.
You guys really are having an impact, I believe. Like I said, a lot of where I am now is due to listening to Free Talk Live. You changed my mind on some very important issues years ago.
To random people tuning in on the radio.
I was kind of stuck in the left-right paradigm. I heard your show by chance on a Saturday night. From there, I went on, joined the Free State Project and become an amplifier. So, I mean, that's really the reason why I amp is because I know that if it wasn't for you guys being on as many stations as you are, I never would have found the ideas of liberty.
Your amp will directly change more lives by getting Free Talk Live in front of people looking for talk radio online and on the air. Find out about giving to our Google AdWords campaign at amp.freetalklive.com. That's amp.freetalklive.com. So you've heard all 3 hours of the latest episode of Free Talk Live, and you're still hungry for liberty-oriented audio content? Did you know that we have another 24/7 audio stream at LRN.fm? The Liberty Radio Network airs the latest episodes of some of the best liberty-oriented podcasts on the internet around the clock. In addition to recorded content, you'll also hear live shows like Free Talk Live, originating from our Keene, New Hampshire studio. So listen anytime at LRN.fm. That's LRN.fm.
Shiny badges on your jacket. Shiny badges.
This is Davi Barker from shinybadges.com, and I just want to personally apologize for airing a jingle week after week, month after month, that turned out to be such an infectious brain worm. So to make it up to you, I'm offering a free gift. The next time you make a purchase at shinybadges.com, write worms in the transaction comments, and I'll send you something weird.
What's up next? Visit the Liberty Radio Network program guide to find out at shows.lrn.fm. That's shows.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. Dial in toll free, 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. And you can join us via Skype at Skype username lrn.fm. Perhaps you could would care to comment about this homeless feeding crackdown. It's happening in Fort Lauderdale now, but it's also happened in Orlando in the past, and maybe where you live. It's not just Florida. There's other cities around the country where there are ordinances, city ordinances that ban the feeding of the homeless. In some cases, banning the gathering of the homeless in any place, in any sort of public park or within a 2 mile radius of City Hall. I've heard of all of these sorts of ordinances, and now it's resulted in a 90-year-old man being arrested, along with a couple of other ministers of a church in Fort Lauderdale. They've been feeding the homeless for 24 years?
Yes.
In this park or in various different parks. And now the government has passed some sort of crazy ordinance, and they are now enforcing it with the violence of the police. Now, of course, the older gentleman in this case has gone peacefully when he has been arrested. The police have not had to use violence against him. But you can better believe that if this 90-year-old man decided he would rather sit down on the concrete than be arrested by these thug cops, that they would get a little bit more violent with him. And, of course, that would make for some even more persuasive video. However, could be a little dangerous to the older gentleman, given that he's 90 and maybe a little on the brittle side. I mean, you get to be 90 years old, you're probably not in your peak of shape. And they could really hurt him if he didn't go along to get along. And if, obviously, I'm not saying he was going along to get along. I don't begrudge anyone who goes along with the police when they're arresting you, because they will hurt you. And in Florida, the Florida sheriffs will have no problem, any of them, with dishing out a little bit of a butt kicking to go along, to motivate you to go along with what they want. So I just think the fact that there's anybody who's 90 years old who's doing activism like this is really inspiring. And we can talk more about it here in a moment. Your calls and thoughts are welcome. Let's bring Dave on the line via Skype. Dave in Montana, you're on Free Talk Live with Ian, Ellen, and Daryl.
Hey, yo. Hey, there's a town in North Carolina that it's against the law to be homeless. But
wow.
I think that's Charlotte, correct?
Yeah, it was on the news about 6 months ago or so. Yeah, I'm not sure the name of the town, though. I know it's in North Carolina. But this feeding of the poor is a religious practice. It's protected under the First Amendment. Jesus says, if you don't feed the poor, you don't feed him.
Well, I mean, it's a nice idea that it should be protected, but obviously the police don't really know that, right? They're arresting people for it.
Should be easily defendable. It's part of the First Amendment is freedom of religion, and you're allowed to practice religion, and Jesus says,
well, the First Amendment says Congress shall make no law, and it would be argued in court that Congress didn't pass this, that
the
it
city
was
council
a
did.
Municipal ordinance, and therefore First Amendment doesn't apply.
Right, and you could make many arguments saying, based on religious grounds, but I don't know if that's going to play out so well, especially in court or, against the police officers who are arresting this guy. They're just, all they see is, oh, this guy's giving out food and it's not being regulated, and we don't know, who he's giving this food to. Like, is he promoting homelessness?
We could say... Then we could make laws saying no burkas, but they would throw a fit about that if you made a law, no woman could wear a burka,
Yeah, I definitely know where you're coming from, Dave. And regarding the First Amendment, it's certainly true that Congress shall make no law, but under the United States Constitution, generally these...
They can't stop you from practicing your religion.
Yeah, that's generally
true. They do it all the time. There are certain faiths that say that, smoking cannabis is something that brings you closer to God. But
no,
yet,
an established religion, I could see them making arguments about the cannabis and this and that. They don't dare tell the Muslims they can't be wearing burqas.
Oh, it depends. I mean, if you, they'll usually tell them that if they're trying to go get their picture taken at the DMV.
And then back in the 1800s, the U.S. military almost invaded Utah over polygamy that was a well-established practice of the Mormon church at the time.
Yeah, so there's a long history of people's freedom of religion being oppressed right here in Keene, New Hampshire. Daryl and I are being told that the Shire Free Church doesn't deserve tax exemption. Essentially, the city's arguing that it's not a church.
Well, and then... It's not just the Shire Free Church. It's the Peaceful Assembly Church in Grafton.
And the Church of the Sword.
Church of the Sword has a parsonage in Westmoreland.
We need a religion court, huh?
Well, we just...
We need a religion court.
I don't think it'll work, though, because the court is on the side of the state in most things, right? So, I don't expect the court to rule in our favor, although it'd be nice if they did. I hope they do, but... And I can't expect that to happen because the court's interested in protecting, first and foremost, the interests of the state. But, Dave, thanks for the call tonight, as always. I appreciate it. Toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. Yeah, I mean, look, the First Amendment, you're right, it does say Congress shall make no law. But in a lot of state constitutions, there are similar provisions. And I can't say that all 50 of them have the freedom of religion expressed, but I imagine that most of them probably do.
Right, and I don't know if you could make the claim that giving out food to the homeless is a regular religious practice. I mean, you could possibly...
Well, you could if that was your regular religious practice.
Yeah, I mean, but couldn't, like, slaughtering goats also be?
Of course. Yeah, and, I mean, whatever God's calling you to do.
Yeah, it could be anything, really. It could just be, like, picking your nose on the subway. Like, that's a religious practice.
It could very well be.
You never know.
Digging for gold.
Yeah. It could be anything. But the thing is, like, it's not so much about religion here. It's more so just about, like, what is right and what's wrong.
I agree.
Are you hurting anybody by doing this?
To me, it shouldn't matter if this guy's a minister of a church or not. And in the case of Food Not Bombs, the people that were involved with that in Orlando, maybe there were some ministers involved in that, maybe not. But I know that some of them were not. They were just folks who wanted to help feed the homeless. And that ultimately is what this boils down to. Not so much an issue of religious freedom, but just a question about public property and tragedy of the commons. And that's what's going on here, is that if it is public property, then people should be able to assemble on that public property, and they should be able to give things away to other people there. And then you could,
well,
make
that would just make sense, Ian.
Right. And
we allowed that for 24 years.
Well, that's the other thing.
The homeless people, they just kept showing up. And we've got to stop this.
Well, of course, this isn't going to stop people being homeless. This is just going to stop them being fed in the government's park. And now, hopefully, the mayor would like the homeless people to be funneled into the government's system.
Right.
So the government system can then probably get a larger budget next year.
And there's a quote from Mr. Abbott.
This is the man arrested, correct?
This is the 90-year-old man that was arrested. He said, "What the city is doing by cutting out feeding is very simple. They are forcing homeless people to go dumpster diving all over again." Adding that, if you can't give someone a meal, then they'll either dumpster dive or starve. He says, they might even steal, and that's what the mayor is forcing the homeless to do.
We'll get a little bit more about this here in moments. We'd love to hear from you, especially if you think that the homeless needed to be just not fed in public. And you support the state, you support the city, in this case, of Fort Lauderdale on this. We'd love to hear from you. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE, because I know those people are out there. Obviously, people hate the homeless, a lot of them, and they'll do anything to put a stop to this. Of course, again, you're not going to stop people from being homeless. And as this gentleman points out, you may actually create more crime, which, is that what you want? 855-450-FREE.
Are you ready to surrender your right to buy body armor? No joke. Congress is now trying to outlaw civilian body armor. And if House Bill H.R. 5344 becomes law, you can kiss your right to protect yourself against rifle bullets goodbye. Don't put off your body armor purchase any longer. Go now to infidelbodyarmor.com. Thousands of military veterans trust their lives to Infidel Body Armor. You should too. Spelled I-N-F-I-D-E-L. Infidel Body Armor. Just won't quit.
This winter, next to water and food, you need a safe, storable fuel supply for your preparedness needs. Spare Fuel is the answer. Unlike gasoline, Spare Fuel can be safely stored with your other supplies for many years and works in any gas-powered vehicle or backup generator. With the bitterly cold temperatures predicted for this winter, now is the best time to stock up on Spare Fuel. So go to GetSpareFuel.com. That's GetSpareFuel.com. GetSpareFuel.com.
It's the Onion Radio News. A crazy man announces plans to stand in a doorway and yell at cars. This is Doyle Redland reporting. Dennis Fife, an Alhambra, California crazy man, held a press conference today to announce his intention to stand in the doorway of the office building at 2600 Kenilworth Avenue and yell at cars all day.
At approximately 9:30 a.m. on the day in question, shortly after I finish lunging at dogs, I will proceed to the front steps of the Simmons Building and yell loudly for 9 hours. The screaming will be broken by a 15-minute fit of rigid catatonia, most likely in the late afternoon.
Among the topics Fife plans to address during his 9-hour rant: the Ace of Diamonds, bookshelves, the man trying to kill him, plastic bags in trees, Trapper John M.D., and papers everywhere. Doyle Redland for the Onion Radio News, online at theonion.com.
This is the Onion News Network.
Ross Ulbricht was arrested by the FBI in 2013 and charged with victimless crimes in relation to allegedly operating the Bitcoin-based Silk Road black market. He has been in a prison cell awaiting trial ever since. If he did it, he's a hero for making the black market a safer place. If he did not, he's a man wrongfully accused. Either way, if you love freedom and want to end the war on drugs, Ross and his family need your support. You can learn more and help fund his defense at FreeRoss.org. That's FreeRoss.org.
DVD, books, music, instruments, periodicals, computers, software, electronics, photo, cell phone, office products, home and garden, bed and bath, furniture, kitchen, pet supplies, automotive, hardware, apparel, shoes, jewelry, grocery, healthcare, sports and outdoors, toys, games, used, and more. It's a department store at your fingertips. Shop.freetalklive.com. Get all your shopping done, get a great deal, and a portion of your purchase goes to benefit Free Talk Live when you enter Amazon via shop.freetalklive.com. What if the key to achieving liberty in your lifetime was to move together with others who think like you? Liberty activists are joining the Free State Project, which is over 70% of the way to its goal of 20,000 participants. And they're already making the move to New Hampshire. The successes are piling up and are proving the Free State Project is a real movement and no longer just a great idea. When you're planning your move, consider Keene. Keene is famous for its civil disobedience and non-cooperation, and there's plenty of political opportunity as well. From demonstrations and vigils to outreach and volunteering, there's a lot going on in Keene. Keene is the liberty media capital of the world, with television, talk radio, and more, all originating here. Though it's more than just activism, with regular social events each week. See what's happening at freekeene.com and get connected with video, audio, free books, a forum, and activist tools you can download and use in your area at freekeene.com. That's freekeene.com.
If you enjoy LRN.FM, please contribute to your favorite shows via their websites and become an amplifier at amp.lrn.fm. That's amp.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. You can bring up whatever you want. 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. We invite you to our website. Get interactive there and do it for free. Those other talk show hosts, they charge you for their sites. Ours, it's free. FreeTalkLive.com. Joining you in the studio tonight, you've got Ian.
Ellen.
And Daryl.
And we're talking about the illegality now in many places, like Fort Lauderdale, Florida, of feeding hungry people. Because it doesn't matter if somebody's homeless or not. When there are these feedings that happen, which now they're trying to crack down on in Fort Lauderdale, they've arrested a 90-year-old man as well as two other ministers from a local church that have been doing homeless feedings for 24 years. They just outlawed them, last year, was it? Very recently.
The arrest began on Tuesday, so I'm guessing it's something that went into effect November 1st.
So they've been
the article doesn't say.
They've been cracking down just recently on this, and it's just absolutely horrible. Now, some people out there would critique these feedings, because again, if you go out and you set up a table with some soup and sandwiches or whatever, it looks like they actually had some pretty nice food here. They got big dishes with people serving out of them, actual like made cooked food.
Caviar and veal.
Because some places it'll just be, you know, bologna sandwiches. And that's fine, too, because beggars can't be choosers, and whatever you give them, hopefully they will be appreciative of. But anybody who walks up can get a sandwich. It's not like there's some sort of litmus to, are you homeless? Show us where your camp's at, your bed is tonight.
You're wearing matching socks. You can't be homeless.
Well, you've got a full set of clothing. What's going on there?
You don't have a long enough beard, sir. You're obviously not.
Where are the needle marks?
Yeah. So, no, I mean, they're gonna feed anybody that walks up to take the food. And some people, when they hear about this kind of activism or this outreach and this this charity, they get upset. They feel like people are just going to take advantage. And, you know, if you teach a man to fish, he can fish for the rest of his life versus you give him fish. And I get all those arguments.
No, Ian, if you teach a man to fish, then he has to buy a fishing permit and then the government still gets their cut.
So,
you know, I've known places in the past, like churches, that run this kind of service out of the building where they'll have people drop off tons of food, like not just boxes and cans, but also like produce.
Yep.
And just give it away. And I knew somebody who would go every week to pick this up, and he may have had a home. I mean, for as low income as it was still a home. But he was able to go there and get, you know, at least $40 worth of groceries every week.
It's true. They've got a place like that here in Keene. I don't think it's church run, but it's a nonprofit agency that collects food and gives it out to whoever comes to get it, basically. And so, you know, if you disagree with that kind of charity, there are other ways to help people, right? And one of them is through coffee.freetalklive.com, where you can You can actually get some great coffee for yourself, and you can help people out around the globe to make a better life for themselves through microloans. So there, you're not just giving somebody something. You're giving them a loan that they have to pay back. And that way you can help them. You're still helping them because they're folks who can't get traditional loans. You know, they just can't go into the bank, sit down and get a loan from the bank that may not even be offered where they live. Or if it was offered, they may not have the credit or whatever requirements would be to actually get something like that. So microloans can help these folks expand their businesses or create a new business. And that helps make them wealthier and makes a better life. You can help that happen by going to coffee.freetalklive.com and get a free pound of coffee. You just pay the shipping cost. It'll be shipped right to you. It's great coffee from BuzzBox. Shade grown, 100% organic, and top 1% grade Arabica. And you're helping make a better life for people. So every 10 Free Talk Live listeners that signs up at coffee.freetalklive.com for the auto ship program, for every 10 listeners, we can fund one new microloan out. And once that microloan's paid back, we'll fund another microloan out of that same money. So the more coffee is bought, the more microloans we can fund, and so on and so forth. Very cool. And you get free coffee the first time out. You pay the shipping cost over at coffee.freetalklive.com. You can then cancel your subscription at any time, but BuzzBox is pretty great coffee, so they're expecting you're really going to enjoy it and stick with it. And again, that's coffee.freetalklive.com. So I'm going to play you some of this audio here from the Daily Mail, just kind of giving you a rundown of what's happening with this 90-year-old man who's been arrested for the dastardly crime of feeding hungry people.
90-year-old Arnold Abbott has been feeding the homeless for nearly two decades in this Fort Lauderdale park. It's a charity he started in honor of his late wife.
Lost her in an accident. I decided that the best living memorial I could put together would be a full-scale feeding program in her name.
How you doing?
But that act of charity is now getting Abbott in trouble with the law. He's been cited by police several times this week for violating a new city ordinance that prohibits feeding the homeless in.
Now, a part of the video footage that needs to be described is they're showing him putting his fingerprints on police paperwork. They're actually processing him right there at the event rather than taking him away to
well,
the police
station. Well, that's
nice. You're right. The cops want to try to make it look like they're not being total thugs here.
We're not arresting him. See, he's not going in the back of the police car with us.
Now, by the way, had he not given them his name and had he refused to give his fingerprints, then things would have been a little bit different.
See, this is so contradictory, though. He's doing something wrong, so they're arresting him, but they're allowing him to finish whatever he's doing that's supposedly wrong.
That's true. They did let him finish, apparently, the feeding of the people, and then they arrested him, which is also very interesting. So, as opposed to Orlando, where they actually did interrupt people who were feeding out there.
Certain outdoor public spaces.
I expected to be arrested tonight because I figured that they would have to have a power pitch showing that the city is more powerful than a frail old man.
I think he just summed it up there. They had to show they were more powerful than a frail old man.
Yeah.
Yep, and look at them go. They are just, you know, knocking people over, like, get out of the way. Can't be feeding these people. And, like, their main victim here, this old guy, like, why would they go after him? He's obviously
he's the ringleader. I mean, the government targets the people who are in charge of something, right?
I know, but he's the most vulnerable, obviously. He's the oldest. He's the one that people are going to sympathize with
that's
the most.
That's true. But they have to enforce their law, Ellen. You know, that's the difficulty these cops are facing here. The cops could also tell the police chief to go screw himself, and they're not going to...
they're not
going to
do that.
They could if they wanted to, though. They could have said, no, this is ridiculous. We're not going to enforce this. Of course, then they would receive some sort of punishment in the form of not getting overtime hours and not
getting promoted. Possibly, you know, put on a
overnight shift.
Paid administrative leave. Although, no, I think if you actually disobey, then they actually like, okay, you're not working next week and you're not getting paid. And then when you come back, you're not getting overtime anymore.
But you're right. I mean, they should, if they want to protect their aura of legitimacy, they should ignore this. But at the same time, if they ignore it, it makes them look like they're impotent. And they just passed a law. I mean, they just can't just pass a law and then not enforce it. They have to be seen as though they are the law and that they are in charge. And that means going up against a 90-year-old man if that's what they have to do.
Right, but this is clearly a bad law. I mean, who really in the city is on their side besides
the mayor?
Enforcers?
You'd be surprised.
The mayor, the city council.
The homeless haters.
The people that don't like homeless people. Although, let me just say, like, if I had absolutely no dwelling of any kind, mm-hmm. and I were going to be actually homeless, I would be homeless at the beach. Like, you know, it doesn't get better than that.
Yeah, I wouldn't want to be in Keene, New Hampshire as a homeless person, but I'm amazed by anybody who's got the huevos to be homeless in Keene, New Hampshire, because it's cold here.
Yeah.
Yeah. Wouldn't be the same way in Florida.
Yeah. What are they going to do, though? Just, like, hop a train down south? I guess they could.
Yes.
Sure. Or just hitchhike. Or just walk. I mean, yeah. It's not like you got anything else to do. So, or responsibilities in life.
I know. They could form one herd of homeless people, all the homeless people in the north, and just have a massive migration.
Well, there are people who would love it if that actually happened, and I'm sure...
But you kind of joke about that, but there actually are, and believe it or not, there are hobo gatherings to where
really?
people that you know, jump trains and whatever, they actually meet up at
now,
various places
from the
across
Rainbow Family?
Yes. Yeah, so I used to live somewhere in Pennsylvania, and there was a hobo gathering in one of the neighboring towns because that's where a lot of the train tracks cross.
Share your thoughts here at 855-450-FREE, 855-450-3733. On feeding the homeless, should it be illegal? It is in a lot of places. Free Talk Live. Have you thought about owning gold? There are lots of reasons to own precious metals. A hedge against inflation. When the dollar tanks, metals go up. A barter currency. You can disempower the Fed by using real money. And no one knows the future. In an economic collapse, metals are likely to be a currency. Do as I've done for years. Buy your gold and silver and precious metals from Midas Resources through gold.freetalklive.com. That's gold.freetalklive.com. Ross Ulbricht was arrested by the FBI in 2013 and charged with victimless crimes in relation to allegedly operating the Bitcoin-based Silk Road black market. He has been in a prison cell awaiting trial ever since. If he did it, he's a hero for making the black market a safer place. If he did not, he's a man wrongfully accused. Either way, if you love freedom and want to end the war on drugs, Ross and his family need your support. You can learn more and help fund his defense at FreeRoss.org. That's FreeRoss.org.
With autumn in the air, it's time to think about getting ready for winter. And it's time to save at herbaldealer.com. You'll find amazing seasonal savings to prepare you for the fight against cold and flu season. Like oregacillin to promote lung health. 30 capsules, regularly $34.95, now only $25. HHA olive leaf, the natural antiviral, normally $16.95, now 60 capsules are just $12. HHA elderberry power, a great flu and virus fighter, regularly $16.95, 60 capsules, now $10. Save on all our homeopathic detoxes. Choose from lungs, kidney, liver, brain, libido, or whole body, normally $26.95, now just $20. Visit herbalhealer.com and click on the Fall Winter Specials button to save on all our natural cold and flu fighting products. Also explore our Herbal Healer Academy correspondence courses that teach you how to handle your health naturally. Herbalhealer.com, healing the world with nature, one person at a time, since 1988.
The warning signs.
At first, he made me feel special. He promised he'd look after me, provide for my future. He broke every promise he made.
Millions of Americans afflicted.
I was ready to leave, but he told me he'd change. So I gave him another chance. I was such a fool.
The consequences.
Things only got worse. He started making my decisions for me about my job, my kids' education, my money, my safety, my future. He took away my choices, but I kept going back to the same politicians.
The diagnosis? Battered voter syndrome.
I fell for the same old lies. They were just playing with my emotions, telling me what I wanted to hear. That's not right.
Stop the insanity of voting for the same old abusers. Declare your independence from the two-party system and join the New Hampshire Liberty Party today at nhliberty.info.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. It's my firm belief that Free Talk Live's AMP program is the best use of your charitable dollar among liberty-oriented organizations. Support all the organizations you love. But make sure you give $5 a month to AMP at amp.freetalklive.com. I love My Magic Mud. I drink a lot of coffee. I had stains on my teeth. Then I found My Magic Mud, and I was told it would remove stains. So I paid attention when I brushed the first time. My Magic Mud is black tooth powder, and the difference it made in my teeth in one application was noticeable. With four, my teeth were as white as you normal folks out there. Please go to MyMagicMud.com and buy a jar. There's 150 applications for $25. You can use Bitcoin. MyMagicMud.com.
You can watch the LRN Studio Cam and chat with other listeners anytime at cam.lrn.fm. That's cam.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live. Dial in toll free and take control of the airwaves. 855-450-FREE is the number. That's 855-450-3733. You can tell us how you feel about the crackdown on feeding people in public. That's what's happening in cities across the United States. Seems like it's happening a lot in Florida. Fort Lauderdale's most recent example, where they've arrested a 90-year-old man for the dastardly crime of feeding hungry people. He's been doing it for 24 years of his life. Your comments are welcome. Also, you can join us via Skype. Skype username here is lrn.fm. And don't forget, if you like Free Talk Live and you want to help support the show, you can do that by shopping with us. Go to shop.freetalklive.com. Enter Amazon through the link that you'll find there. There's Amazon US, Amazon Canada, and Amazon UK. You just do the shopping you need to do. Get the stuff you want. Delivery to your door, and Free Talk Live gets a cut. It's that simple. Go to shop.freetalklive.com as we go to the phones and the fun. Mike is listening in Raleigh to Talk Radio 850. Hey, Mike.
Yeah, hey, I thought you had a great idea about rounding up all of the unfortunates in the world who somehow happen to be homeless and just hurting them like animals down south. But you know what I think would be even a better idea? If you could stop that train, that caravan somewhere along the way, to pick up all the non-caring, non-talented radio jocks who somehow found themselves on the air without any real substance. You think you could pick them up on your way down?
Well, first of all, I think that maybe that's funny, but I think you maybe misunderstood. I don't think Ellen was seriously suggesting that, what she was saying earlier about...
Sure she was.
No.
Play it back.
No,
play it back.
I don't think so. So which radio host would you like to see rounded up?
I say all of you, but listen, I'm not
Just all of us on this show, or all of us on the entire station, or all talk show hosts, period?
Just you. Right now I'm talking about your show, but listen, I don't have
just
time
my
to
show.
Waste my time with you.
Okay, well, we're so glad that you've wasted your time, your precious time to call in and express yourself.
Okay, so what was the claim against me there?
That you were being serious and that you were not, in fact, being tongue-in-cheek.
About rounding up all the homeless. And...
no, I was assuming that they would do this of their own volition.
You weren't advocating.
Yeah,
it.
No, I'm not saying that we should enforce another like concentration camp of homeless people or anything. Not my intention at all. I was completely joking when I said that. Sorry if it was misinterpreted.
Yeah, and I love how he acts as though it's like that we've accidentally ended up on the airwaves on Talk Radio 850.
Yeah, you've not been doing this show on syndication for a decade.
For a decade, no.
The show hasn't existed for, what, a dozen years?
Yeah. Now, look, I'll own the claim that I don't claim to have any real talent in life, which is why, you know, I'm a talk show host. I mean, you don't have to be particularly good at much of anything besides moving your mouth to be a talk show host. And
occasionally push some buttons. Well,
the host generally doesn't have to push buttons. I do because I have that level of technical ability, but that doesn't really factor into whether or not someone can be a talk show host. Talk show hosts are less talented than the board operators that typically are running the operation, because if it wasn't for the board operator typically, then that talk show host in most cases wouldn't know how to turn his microphone on.
Right.
That's a general statement. I don't mean to insult any of the talk show hosts that happen to be listening. I know some of you probably run your own boards because you're working at radio stations and you've come up through the ranks. But like somebody who's one of these Hollywood guys, like, you know, Dennis Miller or Andy Dean, one of these characters who has come up through the ranks of Hollywood and never really spent a day in radio until they got their talk show career. I don't know if those guys would know how to run a board. Maybe I could be wrong, right? Like, maybe Dennis Miller's a real whiz behind the board and knows what he's doing back there, but I don't tend to think that's the case.
I could still operate a cart machine.
Cart machines, wow. Yeah, I remember those things, like the old 8-track tapes.
Yeah.
There was some effort put into this show here, and if it's not your speed, then that's fine. You know, you don't have to listen. There's all kinds of conservaclone talk show hosts out there. If that's what you're looking for, is the conservative guy harping constantly on Barack Obama or Bill Clinton, I mean, you can still listen to a conservative show for 10 minutes and the Clinton name will come up. I mean, it's almost a guarantee. Now, Talk Radio 850 is a great station, by the way, there in Raleigh, WPTK. And it took a long time to get on Talk Radio 850, and you know, you gotta in this business you gotta pay your dues. You gotta get out there. You gotta put it out there for a long time. And I don't claim that Free Talk Live is the best show in the world. I don't know what is the best show in the world. Everybody's got their taste. You know, I like it, and I do the show for me. I do the show that I want to listen to. If I'm bored, then there's a problem. If there's, you know, somebody on the air that I don't want to listen to, then that means the show's going in the wrong direction.
Right.
And I don't want that to happen. But we do what we do here, and that is we take your calls about whatever's on your mind. You just dial in toll-free, 855-450-FREE. You don't have to agree with us. In fact, it's more fun when you don't agree. But if you don't agree, then don't just hang up the phone. Do a drive-by call-in where you call and, you know, drop two sentences on the air and then drop off the line like
that
last guy.
It's really non-committal. Like, oh, you guys suck. By the way, I don't have time for this. Why would you call in the first place?
He had enough time to call and be placed on hold and then get on the air. So he did invest some time in his phone call there. Toll-free number tonight, 855-450-FREE. Still to come here, we've got the crackdown on the black markets around the globe. It's still continuing with more than just the arrests that we told you about yesterday. There apparently have been over a dozen arrests. We'll share more information with you about that. But I'll play the remainder of this interview or this news clip from the Daily Mail about the 90-year-old man arrested for feeding the homeless in Fort Lauderdale, Florida.
Bases.
I expected to be arrested tonight because I figured that they would have to have a power pitch showing that the city is more powerful than a frail old man.
Yep.
And but they generously allowed us to feed all the people here.
This is not a
community. How generous of them. Now, I know that he's trying to be as appreciative as he can in this undesirable situation. And hey, thanks cops for letting us feed everybody before you put me in handcuffs. Now, I don't know if they actually put him in handcuffs. I think they were just kind of leading him away because they don't want to be seen doing that. And already the crowd in this particular case was less than happy with what was going on here. But here's what Mayor Jack Seller has to say about it.
That's turned its back on the homeless or has passed the homeless hate law.
The mayor.
Now, what you missed, he said this is not a city that has turned its back on the homeless. So he's acting like they haven't passed a homeless hate law, meaning that there's no law there that supposedly is targeted against homeless. But that's exactly what this law is targeted against. It's targeted against anybody who's feeding anyone who typically tend to be homeless people. So the law itself doesn't say you can't feed homeless people. It just says you can't feed anybody in the public parks.
No. In his defense, They're not going after the homeless people. They're going after the people that are feeding the homeless people. So, you know, he kind of in a roundabout way is telling the truth when it's not a homeless hate law,
right?
Because it's not criminalizing being homeless.
Good point.
It's criminalizing helping people that are homeless.
Right. He wants to be the only agency, the government. He wants his agency to be the only one that can supposedly help the homeless, and he does not like competition.
Fort Lauderdale says the new ordinance is aimed at trying to control the homeless population and to protect the general public from being overrun by the homeless in public spaces. But Abbott says he will continue to feed the hungry and even sue the city if officials try to stop him.
I will fight them as long as there is breath in my body.
Abbott must appear in court for his citation. He faces a fine or jail time.
What I love about this guy is that he's got the right attitude. You know, he's at the end of his life, And he just doesn't care. I mean, if he had kids, they're all grown up. They probably have kids by now or grandkids. I mean, he probably has great-grandkids.
He's probably got grandkids our age, Ian.
Yeah. Well, no, he probably has great-grandkids at this point. I mean, this guy's old. He's
No. I'm saying his grandchildren are right. Probably about our age.
Which would mean they would also probably have their own kids by now. So, I mean, this guy, he doesn't have anybody who is depending on him. He may not even have a wife at this point because I think he started it in memory of one of his wives, I guess, in the past. And so, I mean, he probably has absolutely no one who's depending on him. So usually that's one of the big objections to people performing civil disobedience is that, oh, well, you know, I've got a baby to take care of or kids at home or my wife would be upset. I mean, these are all legitimate reasons to not engage in civil disobedience. This man in his 90s has none of those reasons.
Right. He's got nothing to lose. So when he risks it all on the line, like, he's not any worse for it. If anything,
that's
he
right.
can only achieve something better. It's like, you know, self-actualization, where he's, you know, finally being able to give back and not suffer any consequences, really. And whatever they are, they're really, you know, not all that important.
Well, jail's a consequence, but, I mean, what does it matter? I mean, if you've got nothing else to do, if this is your mission in life is to feed people, then going to jail is now become part of that mission.
Not to mention, he's 90 and the clock is ticking.
Right. He literally has nothing to lose. I think senior activists like this are so inspirational, and I wish we had more of them. That's the only thing, is that most people in this age range, you know, above 65, they're sitting around watching TV all day, or they're out in the garden instead of doing something that could actually help people. More coming up here, 855-450-FREE. It's Free Talk Live.
Kay Oliver is part of the Tweyambe Women's Group in Jinja, Uganda. She gets old clothes, fixes them up, washes them, and then sells them at the Jinja market. She was quite happy with her success at her business, but realized that a sewing machine would really help her make more money to take care of her two kids. Free Talk Live helped her get that sewing machine. You can help us help more people by getting your coffee through coffee.freetalklive.com. Make a difference, one cup at a time. Get a free pound, try out the subscription, cancel at any time, coffee.freetalklive.com.
The event you've been waiting for is here. Lumber Liquidators, 3rd Annual Fall Flooring Yard Sale. It's your chance to get first quality, full warranty, direct from the mill flooring at unbelievable closeout prices. Like oak laminate for an incredible 19 cents a square foot. And pre-finished 3/4 inch solid maple for just $149. Plus beautiful bamboo for 63% less than other stores. Take advantage of our 20 years of savings with 20-month special financing. And get even more unheard of flooring deals in our stores. Fall Flooring Yard Sale is Thursday through Monday only. Visit LumberLiquidators.com to find a store near you.
Majid lives in Nordevin, Armenia with his wife, kids, and grandkids all in the same house. They have cows, but to compete against the big ranchers, Majid needed to get a loan for more cattle. Free Talk Live helped him get a loan for the cows. He bought them and now he's very happy with the expansion of his farm. You can help us help more people by getting your coffee through coffee.freetalklive.com. Make a difference, one cup at a time. Get a free pound to try out the subscription. Cancel at any time. coffee.freetalklive.com.
You can listen to Free Talk Live on the radio, podcast, satellite, webcam, and our live streams. But did you know you can listen to Free Talk Live from any phone, anywhere? Add this number to your phone, 213-493-0308. It's a long-distance call, so make sure you're familiar with your phone's calling plan. The listen lines are airing the latest episode of Free Talk Live 24 hours a day, including our live shows. Call 213-493-0308. That's 213-493-0308.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number 3 is next after the news here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
This is the Liberty Beat, your daily source for Liberty news and activist updates. Online at thelibertybeat.com. I'm Brian Hagan with your Liberty Beat for Thursday, November 6, 2014. Gold is trading around $1,144, silver $15.39, and Bitcoin is trading around $338. Today's Bitcoin price brought to you by ExpressCoin, the fastest and most reliable way to buy Bitcoin. Buy Bitcoin today at ExpressCoin.com. Today's edition of the Liberty Beat brought to you by our newest sponsor, eFoods Direct. Redefining the way you think about storable food. Easy to make and great tasting, with a shelf life of over 25 years. To celebrate our new partnership, eFoods Direct is offering Liberty Beat listeners 10% off their purchases. To take advantage of this exciting offer, call 800-620-5520 and mention coupon code LibertyBeat. To learn more or to buy online, visit eFoodsDirect.com. In the news, on Wednesday, Thousands of protesters around the world took part in the Million Mask March, with demonstrators in Washington, D.C. and London challenging the police head-on. London police arrested 10 people after protesters clashed with police officers and allegedly committed assault. At one point, the protesters grabbed metal barriers, which separated police from the activists. In Washington, D.C., protesters also wrestled with police over metal barriers. The mass protesters in the nation's capital verbally challenged the police and called for an end to government corruption. The BBC reports Egypt's policies toward protesting citizens are under review by the Human Rights Council of the U.S.-funded United Nations. Since 2011, revolution has rocked Egypt and caused major upheaval following the ouster of longtime president Hosni Mubarak. After democratically elected Mohamed Morsi was removed by a military coup last year, military ruler President al-Sisi has been heavily criticized by U.S. and European nations for perpetrating violence against innocent protesters exercising political speech. However, the United States continues to work with al-Sisi. As during the reign of Mubarak, the United States sends Egypt roughly $3 billion in foreign aid each year. Over 2,000 people have died in the conflict in Egypt. On Tuesday, Hawaiian voters decided to ban the growing of genetically modified crops. The new measure creates a temporary moratorium on GM crops until further health and environmental studies are completed. Support for Liberty Beat comes from Central Texas Gunworks, your online source for firearms, firearm accessories, and ammunition. They take major credit cards and now accept Bitcoin. Visit them online at shop.centraltexasgunworks.com. Support also comes from Marjorie Wildcraft's Grow Your Own Groceries. Homegrown food on every table. That's growyourowngroceries.org. This is the Liberty Beat for Thursday, November 6th, 2014. Check out the website at thelibertybeat.com and like us on Facebook at facebook.com/thelibertybeat. On Wednesday, President Barack Obama said he would work with Congress on new war powers to fight Islamic State militants and expressed cautious optimism about whether the international face-off over Iran's nuclear program will be resolved. Two issues that could prove harder for the White House to maneuver with Republicans in charge on Capitol Hill. The Associated Press reports that Obama spoke at a news conference the day after his party was thrashed by Republicans in elections, leaving the Republicans soon to be in charge of both the House and the Senate. Obama's decision will test the ability of the divided Congress to agree on a war strategy for Iraq and Syria. A St. Louis circuit judge has ruled Missouri's ban on same-sex marriages as unconstitutional. Judge Rex Burleson called the freedom to marry a fundamental right deeply rooted in the history of the United States. The news comes a day after a federal judge ruled a similar ban in Kansas was in violation of the Constitution. On Monday, a district judge threw out an alleged 1993 confession from Daniel Villegas, the Texas man who spent 19 years behind bars for a murder he did not commit. The district judge stated that the confession could not be used as evidence in an upcoming retrial because it was coerced by police. Support for Liberty Beat comes from Midas Resources Incorporated, helping clients convert their paper 401ks and IRAs to solid gold and silver. Get their 10 Reasons book free by calling 800-686-2237. That's 800-686-2237. Support also comes from Sovereign Living, a podcast, blog, and reality show about what it takes to live a voluntary and natural life. Check out the blog at sovereignliving.com and watch episode 1 of the soon-to-be-released reality show at sovereignliving.tv. This is the Liberty Beat for Thursday, November 6, 2014. I'm Brian Hagan reporting. Reminding you, spread liberty with a smile.
Following reports earlier today that Indiana University freshman Lawrence Plotnick's roommate Brian Tabor has found an excuse to go home every weekend since August, Plotnick spoke to Onion reporters about his roommate's frequent trips to his nearby hometown of Terre Haute, Indiana.
Every week since we got here, it seems like every time I ask him if he wants to hang out on Friday, he has some wedding or birthday party or something. In fact, I'm pretty sure he hasn't spent a single Friday or Saturday night on campus in the past 6 months.
Plotnick went on to cite a variety of far-ranging excuses used by his roommate to justify his constant visits home, including various family functions, a visiting friend from China, as well as his occasional desire to, quote, just hang out at home for a couple of days.
I mean, I suppose I vaguely understood when he had to go back in November because his best friend's grandfather died, but last weekend, he had to go back for his aunt and uncle's wedding anniversary. He said he couldn't miss it.
This is the Onion News Network.
Talk Live. Dial in toll free and bring up anything you want. 855-450-FREE. The Darknet crackdown has expanded. Last night we talked about the Silk Road 2.0. It was taken down. The alleged operator, Blake Benthal, I believe was his name, has been arrested, charged with supposed crimes, which of course none of them have a victim. And these supposed crimes will possibly put him in prison for the rest of his life. Turns out there was more to the takedown than that. Also, for those of you just tuning in, we've been talking quite a bit about the crackdown against people feeding homeless folks or feeding anyone in public parks. It's that crackdown is currently happening in Fort Lauderdale, but it's also been known to happen just about anywhere else. It's a fairly large city. So you're welcome to comment on that still if you would like to add into the discussion. With you in the studio tonight, you've got Ian,
Ellen,
and Daryl.
And Wired.com reporting on the latest from the crackdown here worldwide, a global web crackdown called Operation Onimus. It first came to light yesterday. It looked like a targeted strike against a few high-value targets to the dark web drug trade. Now the full scope of that international law enforcement crackdown has been revealed, and it's a scorched earth purge of the internet underground. On Friday, the European police agency Europol, along with the FBI and Department of Homeland Security, announced that the operation has now arrested 17 people in as many countries and seized hundreds of dark web domains associated with well over a dozen black market websites. In addition to the takedowns of drug markets Silk Road 2, Cloud 9, and Hydra revealed on Thursday, it's also busted contraband markets like Pandora, Blue Sky, Topics, FlugsVamp, Cannabis Road, and Black Markets. Other takedown targets included money laundering sites like Cash Machine, Cash Flow, Golden Nugget, and Fast Cash. And most of these I've never even heard of before. And agents have taken from criminal suspects more than $1 million worth of Bitcoin, $250,000 in cash, as well as an assortment of computers, drugs, gold, silver, and weapons that they had yet to fully catalog.
Gold and silver. See, that proves the conspiracy from earlier. The feds and the central banks are behind the gold and silver, because why else would that be sold on the dark net unless they were trying to avoid being connected to the central banks?
Maybe the banks are behind the dark net.
I'm just surprised at the amount of wealth that is like disappearing because of this.
Oh,
and
no,
also,
it won't be disappearing. It'll be going to the hands of the federal agents.
And then at some point, they'll have to auction it off.
Yeah.
But what new websites are going to spring up because of this? I mean, when the first Silk Road was shut down, there was a huge rebound from that.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, Silk Road 2.0, although it's a more familiar name, so of course people are going to use that more, but I'm sure that there's going to be many other websites now because of this.
Right now on the Agora site, there's the site called Agora Marketplace. I see there are 12,900 listings for drugs, counterfeits, 500-plus listings, forgeries, 200-plus, jewelry, 100-plus, tobacco, 200, services, 400, weapons, 100, electronics, 100. So there's plenty of listings on there. In fact, Agora Marketplace has been going strong since last year, and they are one of the sites that is still online. So I imagine that quite a bit of business is going to be shuffling over there. Likely as we speak, but apparently this crackdown was much larger than initially it had appeared to be, and all the agency says it seized 414 of the .onion domains. Now, we were talking about this darknet, as it's called. That is, the .onion is an indicator. When you see a .onion, so you know the http://, and then whatever, .com, well, .onion shows you that it's one of these hidden sites. So if you see a .onion and you try clicking on it with your regular web browser, it won't work. You have to have the special Tor browser to be able to access these sites. Now, the big obvious question here, and I believe Wired addresses it to some extent here in a moment, but the big question is, how are these federal agencies finding out the locations of these websites? It's one thing to take down one site in a year, but to take down 414 of them, what are they doing? There must be some sort of backdoor. Have they cracked into the Tor project?
Well, Brian Sovereign has been saying for a while that Tor is not as secure as it once was, or as secure as it could be.
So the way Tor functions is just bouncing IP addresses around, right?
That's a way to describe it, as I understand it.
That's the way the nodes work. There's nodes, and then there's the network, and then there's the relays, and...
It's pretty complicated, but yeah, you're essentially obscuring people's locations by bouncing the traffic to multiple locations. But that's a very simplified version of what's going on, right?
Right. Well, I'm not claiming to be an expert on the topic.
Me neither. So I know somebody out there is listening, shouting at their radio, "That's not how it works!"
Most of what I know about how Tor works... I learned from listening to Private Manning explain how Tor works when there was the hearing on, it was before the trial began, but there was the hearing and Private Manning was giving an explanation of why and how the various things were done of documents being leaked to WikiLeaks. And there was a fairly good explanation of the Onion router in like the 30-minute speech that was given.
Now, it's hard to even imagine that there were 414 active domains that were available on the deep web for buying and selling drugs and things like that. I don't know what they mean when they say they've seized 414.onion domains. That could mean a variety of different things.
Right, because each one of the sites could have had 5 or 10 different domains.
It could have, yeah. And or maybe they took down a server that was serving out a bunch of different domains that,
right.
You know, maybe some of them had to do with these black markets, maybe others didn't, but they just took the whole thing down. So where they get that number from, I don't know, but it's interesting that they've only arrested 17 people. So they've taken down 414 domains. Presumably there would be more than 17 people involved in operating those domains. So
right. Well, as you said earlier, one of the weakest links are just the humans that run it. So perhaps it was something to do with communications between, you know, people who were trusted that shouldn't have been.
Absolutely, that could be the case. We don't know what the individual stories are and whether or not, you know, who these 17 people are and which sites they were involved with. We don't know. And it'll, of course, be tragic if there are some people out there who, you know, who are running these underground drug sites that don't get the same level of attention that Ross Ulbricht or now Blake Benthal do, and yet they're still facing similar criminal charges. Because I think, you know, these guys are doing, I think they're doing a service for humanity by running these sites. They're helping move black market transactions onto the internet instead of on the streets. And that means that people are going to be safer, that there won't be as much, you know, violent drug transaction happening in reality. They'll be happening anonymously online, which helps protect people. And that helps keep people safe. So by taking down sites, the feds are just pushing drug transactions back into the streets and making it more dangerous. So they say they've seized 414 of these Onion domains, and the web addresses used by the anonymity software Tor that hides the physical locations of those site servers, or at least so we thought. When Wired spoke Thursday night with Troels Orting, the head of the European Cybercrime Center, he said his staff hadn't even had time to assemble the full list of sites that it has pulled down in the sprawling operation. He said, quote, "One of the primary targets was the Silk Road guy," referring to Blake Benthal, the 26-year-old coder arrested in San Francisco and accused of managing the popular Silk Road 2.0 drug site. "But we also decided to see if we could identify more of the administrators of these sites and remove their infrastructure as well. Some moved before we could act, but we've taken most of our targets down." Europol didn't immediately share the details of the 17 arrests related to the operation, but aside from Benthal, they did reveal earlier on Thursday that two individuals had been arrested in Dublin in a large dark web-related drug bust. Just how law enforcement agents were able to locate the dark web sites despite their use of the Tor anonymity software remains a looming mystery. In its criminal complaint against Benthal. For instance, the FBI agent in the case writes merely that in May of 2014 that they, quote, "identified a server located in a foreign country believed to be hosting Silk Road 2.0 at that time," without explaining how they bypassed Tor's protections against identifying locations. So that still we've yet to find out in this case or in the previous Silk Road takedown. We'll tell you more about the expansion of this war against the freedom to buy and sell things on the internet. It's Free Talk Live.
Hi, everyone. I'm Chuck Woolery. After putting a few thousand couples together on Love Connection, you know that nothing kills romance faster than bad breath. Smart Mouth gets at the cause of bad breath without the burn, and you get clean breath for about 12 hours. Other mouthwashes only prevent bad breath for about an hour. Gum and mints, well, they just cover it up. Use Smart Mouth in the morning for great breath all day. Rinse in the evening for clean, kissable breath all night. You can even wake up without morning breath. Smart Mouth, for 12 hours of real clean breath, look for the green box at your favorite store.
Here's a good idea. When you have a legal matter like creating your will or legally setting up a business with a corporation or LLC, you don't necessarily need a law firm. Use LegalZoom.com. At LegalZoom.com, you answer straightforward questions online and they take care of the rest. They even review your answers for common mistakes and guarantee your satisfaction. Free Talk Live listeners, you'll get 10% off your order by typing in FTL in the referral box at purchase. Don't procrastinate with these important legal documents. LegalZoom.com.
Again, the Congressional Budget Office sounds the alarm. This time warns of Greek-style U.S. debt crises. You heard me right. The GAO is drawing a parallel between the U.S. economy, its debt, and the current Greek economic meltdown. With the debt-to-GDP chart climbing into unfamiliar territory, the growing budget deficit will rise to unsupportable levels. Hi, this is Ted Anderson. The Federal Debt and Risk of Financial Crises document the CBO has published is a must-read for every American. Covering the risk of continued deficit spending coupled with an aging population and the rising interest rates spell economic disaster. It's imperative that you get a copy of this document and study it for yourself. Call me today at 800-686-2237 and I'll send you a free copy. Again, call 800-686-2237 and ask for your copy of the CBO document. Once again, you need to read this government report. Call 800-686-2237.
Since time began, tyrants have taken aim at personal liberties. Now there's a movie that aims back.
The government has no more right to tell us what to put in our bodies than they have to take our guns or tell us what books we can read.
Six drug police were eaten by bears while raiding a marijuana farm.
On your knees, you dirty hippies! Jesus. On your knees!
What's the problem, officer?
Today, many cops who enforce pot laws do so only because it provides them with cushy jobs, good benefits, and a chance to push people around.
I was an undercover narcotics officer. The drug war is nothing but a farce.
The Second Amendment says you gotta keep you and your gat intact.
Guns and Weed, the Road to Freedom. A film by Michael W. Dean and Nima Vadavi.
DVD available now at gunsandweed.com or on Amazon. Hey! That's gunsandweed.com. Makes the perfect gift. Remember, that's gunsandweed.com.
Did you know that you can listen to and watch Free Talk Live during our live show 7 days a week from 7 to 10 p.m. Eastern via our studio cam at cam.freetalklive.com? Not only that, but you can also chat with other listeners at the same time. Do I need to mention that both the studio cam and chat room are totally free? Outside of Free Talk Live's live hours, you won't see a cam feed, but we'll hear audio from the Liberty Radio Network. So listen, watch, and chat all free at cam.freetalklive.com. That's cam.freetalklive.com.
Are you tired of your taxes funding endless occupations around the world? Antiwar.com is run by people who understand that wars abroad become wars at home, wars on our freedoms. Antiwar.com is dedicated to bringing you the latest in news, views, interviews, and reviews from the top movers and shakers in the anti-occupation movement. Antiwar.com has it all, from thorough foreign policy analysis to interviews with whistleblowers who used to run the military-industrial complex. Antiwar, pro-free market. That's Antiwar.com.
You're listening to the best liberty-oriented audio streamed around the clock, on the air, and online. This is the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
This is Free Talk Live. You dial in toll-free and bring up anything you want. At 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. The global crackdown is continuing on the underground black market websites like Silk Road 2.0. According to the FBI and Europol, they have taken down hundreds of onion domain names and also have arrested 17 people. They have yet to reveal details on those 17 arrests and those 400 plus onion domains, so we don't really know exactly who they've hit, but apparently some of the sites that are down include sites like Silk Road 2, Cloud9, Hydra, Topics, Blue Sky, Pandora, Flugsvamp, Cannabis Road, and Black Market.
Of those sites, I've only heard of one or two.
I've heard of Pandora, but I thought it was some music streaming app.
Yeah, me too.
Didn't know that they sold drugs.
Pandora's box, I guess that makes sense.
Apparently they have been, yeah, it's a good point. Apparently maybe Pandora's had an unseen wing of their business, or it had nothing whatsoever to do with the Pandora music.
No, the music was just a cover.
Well, it is
the music was a front.
Well, it's expensive to do that music licensing. Maybe they were selling drugs to cover the cost of the music licensing.
You never know.
So toll-free number tonight, 855-450-FREE. Don't forget, you can join us online at freetalklive.com. And another great site to check out when you're online is antiwar.com, where they have the answers and the facts and the readership. But what they don't have is a pot of gold, because they're not selling drugs at antiwar.com. The War Machine has the magic of the Federal Reserve's printing press and the mainstream media, but all antiwar.com has is you. They're down to a skeleton crew with minimal pay, and they're committed to keeping their website online with the best of the worst of all of the bad news of the world, but they can't do it for free. They need your help and your donation. Please go to antiwar.com and donate, or give them a call today. They do proudly and gladly take Bitcoin. antiwar.com/donate. That's antiwar.com, because war is the health of the state, and the war on drugs continues to go on. This futile, pointless exercise, which just results in more peaceful people like Blake Benthal and the other 16 people that they've arrested here, more peaceful people being put behind bars, and ultimately the drugs won't be stopped. Blake Benthal's site was processing $8 million in transactions every single month. The administrators were pulling down around $400,000 worth of Bitcoin in, you know, fees and profits for them every single month. There's $400,000, you know, even if you divvied it up between you and four operators, $100,000 is, or you and three operators, $100,000 is a decent amount of money to sit around and run a website per month.
So how do I start one of these dot onions?
You better know your stuff is how you start the dot onion. You better be really careful is how you start one of these things up.
And you better not be you. You better be someone else.
You better be someone who knows their programming and knows how to keep a site safe from attack. Because when you're running one of these underground sites, not only are you needing to be concerned about the federal government and them coming in with a SWAT team and kicking in your door and stealing all of your stuff and taking your own body and putting you in a jail cell, not only do you need to be concerned from an operational security aspect there, but you also have to be concerned about some unscrupulous individuals attacking your site. They know you've got money. They know that as a drug sales site, you're holding on to likely a fairly large cache of Bitcoins. And if they can get access to that by hacking your server, then you damn well better believe they're going to try that. So you're constantly under attack when it running one of these sites.
Right. And the more money is in one place, the less scruples people will have.
Exactly. The more desperate things they'll be willing to try.
That's why you need to open up a car wash and make sure that you rewatch every episode of Breaking Bad.
So they're targeting, again, a lot of people here. Europol, the FBI, Department of Homeland Security. This is an international bust. Dozens of countries involved, over a dozen arrests. And still the big question is, how did they find the location of these servers? Did the feds find a new vulnerability in Tor's well-tested anonymity shield? Or was there a backdoor put in the first place?
Well, is there any way to verify this number? Like, can
the number
we even,
of arrests
yeah,
or what?
Can we even be sure that there was this many websites taken down?
The only way you'd know is to try to, well, if they release the list, they say they're going to release that information that they just haven't yet. But presuming they release the list, you could go through the list and
because
see if the sites are down.
I'm just thinking perhaps it would be in their interest somehow if they were to exaggerate the number a little bit.
It of sounds course. Exaggerated.
To scare people out of it. Like, well, look at all these people who were arrested and caught. You better not think about starting up another one, too.
Just like with, you know, the wars going on in the Middle East, it benefits the U.S. government to undercount the number of civilians that are killed and overcount the number of, you know, quote-unquote suspected terrorists that are killed. That's why they make the definition so vague, to where basically any male that could possibly have carried a weapon is now a suspected insurgent.
Let's go to Nathan in Texas on Skype. You're on Free Talk Live, Nathan, with Ian, Ellen, and Daryl.
That's great, Daryl. You beat me to the Breaking Bad joke there. So I wanted to talk about weaknesses in the Tor network.
Okay. Go for it.
So there are a couple that have been in the news recently. There was a talk supposedly going to be given by an Alexander Blinken about weaknesses, how that you could easily break Tor. But the talk was mysteriously canceled earlier this year. So there was speculation that maybe their bosses at the university told them not to do it, or you know, maybe the government wanted them to keep it hush-hush, or for whatever reason, nobody knows. But they claimed to have a technique that could break Tor. And there was just a paper released. Let's see. The name is Alex Buryukov, and it's called Bitcoin over Tor Isn't a Good Idea. And the claim in this paper is that someone using Bitcoin over Tor could be attacked in that all their traffic could get routed through a single Tor node, and then a man-in-the-middle attack could become possible.
Okay, so yeah, there have been some questions about Tor and its reliability, but it was after that MIT thing that you were talking about that didn't Tor come out and say, yeah, there was a problem, but we've patched it? I mean, isn't that what happened?
Well, the researchers didn't release their technique, I thought, so it would only be their guess that they actually did patch it. And even if they did patch it, they still obviously would have access to that technique for a number of months, and so you know, during that time, they could have maybe compromised a lot of these sites that they're talking about.
I see what you mean. So that when they had the window of opportunity, they used that to its maximum extent. So even if it was patched and is safe now, if it was vulnerable for 2 months earlier this year, then they could have used that time window to take down these sites.
Exactly. And, you know, the Tor is still an ongoing project. It's still basically in beta, so you shouldn't depend on it for your multi-million Walter White empire or anything.
Thanks for the like call. Go ahead.
I was going to say, even if you use Tor right now, you know, sometimes you'll get a message that'll say, warning, this site is trying to use a Canvas JavaScript, whatever.
You don't want to turn JavaScript on if you're on Tor. Thanks for the call tonight, Nathan. Appreciate it. Toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. And I think the Tor browser used to come with JavaScript turned on. So it was vulnerable right out of the box. It's Free Talk Live.
I am so excited. My Ghost 80% AR-15 rifle just arrived. I bought it from Guns80.com. I've wanted an 80% AR-15 ever since my buddy Mark got his. I just had to have one. And when I was on the website at Guns80.com, not only did they have a great deal on the Ghost ARs, but I also found lots of other really cool stuff. And they're 80% specialists. At Guns80.com, they have a great selection of pistol kits and rifle kits. All of them can be legally shipped straight to your front door. 80% lowers and jigs starting at $50. 80% rifle kits, $500. Everything you need to build an AR in your home, all at Guns80.com. Cool part, 100% legal in most states. So, get your AR-15 today. I got mine. Now it's your turn. Go to Guns80.com. I can't wait to get mine built. Get your Ghost AR-15 today at Guns80.com. Go to Guns80.com. That's Guns, the number 880.com.
Why did you move to the Shire?
I moved here to the Shire because there's other people around who take liberty just as seriously as I do.
I moved to the Shire because I saw videos of people challenging authority and thought that I could get support myself. It called to me, like, do this right now.
I wanted to be around people like me who got it. And once I got here, I knew there was nowhere else that I wanted to be.
I've always wanted to change the world. So I moved to the Shire to join people who were actually working towards doing the same thing.
The people here are awesome, loving, and positive. It was for the adventure and for the feeling of something important is happening here. And I just wanted to come to sort of be part of that.
Visit ShireSociety.com to read and sign the Shire Society Declaration and learn the reasons why, if you love liberty, you should immigrate to the Shire. Plus, add yourself to the Shire map at ShireSociety.com. That's ShireSociety.com.
This is Mark of Free Talk Live. We've been witnessing a meltdown of the economic engine that powers our country. With a printing press tethered to Washington bureaucrats and New York central bankers, how can we trust paper money? For years, I've been buying gold and silver from Midas Resources, and you should too. Call 877-357-9938 for a free book titled 10 Reasons to Own Gold, or go to gold.freetalklive.com. Again, 877-357-9938. 877-357-9938. The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. You likely buy all kinds of things online. Amazon is the largest online retailer. You can get what you need at the same prices with free Super Saver shipping by going to shop.freetalklive.com. Please do your online shopping at shop.freetalklive.com.
Hi, I'm Derek J. To me, an activist's calling is to actively work to advance a cause. The cause for which I work is personal freedom. I believe my life is best when I engage in voluntary interactions and self-government. I reject the idea that anyone else has a higher claim to my life or my body than I do. I see people who call themselves the government as a threat to my personal freedom. I realize you may feel differently, but my relationship with the people who call themselves the government is completely involuntary. If Starbucks used some of its money to drop bombs, I wouldn't shop there. So why would I support the American Empire? The Empire does not require my consent.
Derek J's Victimless Crime Spree. Watch it for free and order the Director's Cut DVD at victimlesscrimespree.com. That's victimlesscrimespree.com.
While our satellite channel is free to listen to, it's not free for us. You can help us cover our satellite costs with the chip-in on the right side of the page at lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. You may bring up anything. Just dial in toll-free, 855-450-FREE. That's the Pro XPN toll-free line, 855-450-3733. Join us online at freetalklive.com. And Free Talk Live is brought to you by Keenvention. Coming up probably tonight, I will be releasing the very first video from Keenvention 2014. The legislative panel. We had some experts at Keenvention talking about how to make a difference in the legislative process in New Hampshire, because in New Hampshire, you actually can have an effect on the legislative process. There's a lot of different ways for you to get involved, either as running as a legislator or just going up to Concord and testifying on bills. Or, Daryl, as you're doing, you're actually writing bills. You're
yes.
not an elected representative, but you're writing your own bills anyway.
Yes, because somebody had told me that the best way to get a state rep to introduce something is to have a written proposal ready for them, because that way they don't have to think about it.
I totally agree. I mean, if I was just kind of putting myself in the shoes of a state rep, I mean, if I were to somehow magically be elected state rep here in Keene, New Hampshire, which of course is a near impossible thing to achieve, I wouldn't want to quit doing Free Talk Live or whatever.
Right.
So I'd still have all my business responsibilities, and on top of that, I'd have to go to Concord two or three times a week. To go to various different hearings, basically spend all day in Concord for two or three days every single week for a good chunk of the year, like the wintertime months for the most part are the real heavy. So it's like the most difficult time to actually travel. You have to go to Concord
from
all
like
the time.
January to May.
Yeah. And I'd still have all my responsibilities, and man, it would be really difficult to actually have to read and write a bunch of bills and legislation and all that within that time. So if.
Well, actually, the period in New Hampshire, the period for filing bills, mm-hmm. because they have to be filed before the beginning of the legislative year, it begins Wednesday, November 12th and ends December 5th. So the people that got elected 4 days ago,
they've got to have bills ready to roll.
They have to
saying.
Have bills ready to roll
wow.
by like 5 days from now.
Yeah, there's no way they're taking time out of their day to write all of these bills.
How can they file a bill if they haven't even been sworn in yet? How does that happen?
Those are the I didn't write the rule. I just told you what it
yeah,
was.
Yeah, okay.
And for the people that say that civil disobedience never accomplishes anything,
There's actually been a good bit of civil disobedience that happened on Election Day in New Hampshire.
What does that mean? What happened?
Well, there was a law that went into effect on September 1st that said that it's illegal to post a picture of your ballot online. And a bunch of people did that. I did that. And I even tagged it of, I posted this picture in the ballot booth because the...
Did you alert the Attorney General to your civil disobedience?
I did not call him, okay. But I did post Bill Gardner come at me. I even told that to a news reporter for New Hampshire One.
That's the name of the Secretary of State.
Yes.
Okay.
And the Concord Monitor now has a story about this. And apparently some legislators are saying, hey, you know what? It's a silly law. We're going to try to overturn this.
So you're saying that the civil disobedience of people may be resulting in the law being overturned.
It definitely did, because had there not been the civil disobedience, there would not have been the media about it.
Good point.
And there would not have been state reps getting called from the media, hey, do you guys going to do anything about this weird, silly law?
So even though in New Hampshire, again, by the way, for those who don't know, the reason why the three of us are here tonight is together is because of the Free State Project. The idea being, let's get liberty-oriented people, people who love freedom, people that understand that in order to be free, you have to allow others to be free, and that freedom means you should be free to live your life how you want, so long as you don't harm anyone else. We're getting people who think like that to move together, to not to one town like Keene, New Hampshire, but all across New Hampshire. That's the destination. In fact, Ellen, you don't even live in Keene anymore. You live elsewhere in New Hampshire.
Yeah, so that's the long drive.
Yeah, that's the important part, is to get people who love liberty here in New Hampshire. And many of them have already won election to office. But, Daryl, there was a bill you put forth last year that wasn't even introduced by a Free State Project participant. So, you know, even if you don't know people in the state legislature, like, you know, we know people in the legislature here. Even if you don't know people, you can still find some of them that are willing to listen to you and might even be willing to take the bill that you've proposed and actually put it forward. So if you want to learn more about the legislative process, I'll be posting over at keenvention.info. I'll be posting this over an hour-long video of three guys who've got a lot of experience in Concord, and they'll explain to you what, you know, what makes New Hampshire special. There's a lot that really makes New Hampshire special. It's an accessible legislature. It's a citizen legislature. It's people, not lawyers, for the most part, who make up the legislature here. And that means that they're just more average folks involved, and they're easily, you know, more easily able to reach those people. You can have a conversation with them. And some of them will actually take your legislation that you're going to propose and put it forth. And that means, you know, that doesn't happen anywhere else. You can't even talk to the legislature in Florida. Those people don't want to hear what you have to say. That's where I'm from. And they certainly wouldn't give a damn if you propose some sort of legislation to them. They don't care about you.
Right. But I would agree with you. A lot of people that have positions around here in the government are very easy to approach, very easy to talk to. You know, you can just meet them standing outside sometimes.
Yep. And not that I'm impressed by them. I mean, it's not like I'm awed by their glory or anything like that when I meet them. But it's just nice to be able to meet them as another human being. You know, human to human. They aren't as, they're not as snooty, I don't think, generally here.
Right. And the bar that I went to on Tuesday night for trivia with a couple of people here in town... Mm-hmm. The Democrats were having their election party at that bar, although they were in the restaurant portion of the place, but they had to walk through the bar to get to the restroom. And I would point out to my friends, oh, yeah, that's State Rep so-and-so. That's our senator. That's this person. And there were just so many of them. And, you know, in most places, one, they wouldn't be in a regular restaurant. They'd
with
be
the little people.
With the little people.
Or they'll have the back room to themselves or something, right?
And two, you know, I wouldn't have any clue who they were. Be like, oh, yeah, I think I've seen that guy on TV before, but yeah. I don't know who he is.
Yeah, that's a great point. You not only can you reach them just generally by calling them and talking to them at their home or their cell phone, which is usually listed on the state's website, but you see them all around town. I mean, if you're paying if you pay attention to the political process in New Hampshire and you know who the players, you could still be ignorant of it if you wanted to in New Hampshire and just not know anything about it. But if you know who these players are, you see them around. I was driving down the street the other day, and I saw the state senator pass me in the other lane. I mean, it's just, you recognize these folks. I see them multiple times every single year, and that means they see you. and they get to know who you are. And you know, even if they don't really care what you think, at the very least, they have to at least listen to you and, you know, and be there in physical reality, and they can't get away from you. They don't have secretaries. They don't have a staff. In the state house, all they get is a locker. That's all they have.
If they're lucky.
Really?
That they don't have enough lockers for all 400.
So is it only the ones who are seniors, or do they do like when I say seniors, like they've been there for a while?
I don't know how they do it.
Drawing lots?
Probably, but I have heard that not everybody has a locker.
Or you could just volunteer to not have a locker, like, oh, it's okay, right. I don't need that. Yeah, that's amazing.
I don't know. Maybe it's more of a, you know, the longer you've been there, the more right you have to a locker.
Well, they do give the people who've been there for a while preference when it comes to picking their panels or whatever.
The committees.
The committees.
And then the Senate actually does have, like, a small semblance of something that's a staff. Like, each committee has a clerk.
Ah, okay.
That works in an office in Concord. But that's it.
That's it. Yeah. So if you want to learn more, go to freestateproject.org, get signed up, and join over 16,000 people who are now pledged to make the move here, just as we've done. We're early movers. The idea is we want to get to 20,000 signatures, 20,000 people who pledged to move, and then there's a five-year window. Once we hit 20,000, there'll be a five-year window where everybody has to make the move up here and get even more active. Already, Free Staters are winning. Election already, and we only have 1,600 people who are here now as part of the Free State Project. What's it going to be like when we have 5,000 or 10,000 people here? We're already being called the single greatest threat to the state. That's already happening, and the move hasn't even officially begun. So why would you want to be anywhere else? 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. More on the Darknet takedown. There's still more to come on that. You can also share your thoughts on anything here at 855-450-FREE. This is Free Talk Live. Free Talk Live has partnered with Amazon, the largest internet retailer. Imagine a department store category, and Amazon has it. Books, electronics, office products, furniture, jewelry, automotive, toys, clothing, sporting goods, and dozens of other categories. Now you can shop and support Free Talk Live by entering Amazon through our website. Go to shop.freetalklive.com, and Amazon will send us a portion of your purchase. You're going to do the shopping anyway, so remember to enter through our site at shop.freetalklive.com. That's shop.freetalklive.com.
Chuck Woolery here. You know, I've talked before about Australian Dream, the effective arthritis pain relief cream that doesn't burn, isn't greasy, and has no odor. Now there's new Australian Dream back pain cream with all those great benefits. But this penetrating formula can help relieve your simple back pain. And it's backed by an empty jar guarantee. If you're not satisfied, you can send back the empty jar for a full refund. But I don't think you will, because Australian Dream really works. Don't let back pain ruin your day. Get Australian Dream back pain cream at Walgreens.
Hi folks, Ronnie McMullen here for Life Change Tea. Healthcare is a problem, whether you're for or against Obamacare. It's a mess. My question is, who do you trust? Do you want to be told what to do, or do you want to make your own decision? My opinion, preventative maintenance. Keeping your colon clean is preventative maintenance. A little exercise, a balanced diet, and drinking Life Change Tea. It tastes great, and it helps with constipation, high cholesterol, liver problems, acid reflux, and much, much more. And with the holiday season upon us, you can get some extra tea for free. Don't wait for Obama. Make your own decision. Order now. Call us at 928-308-0408. That's 928-308-0408. Or you can log on to getthetea.com. That's getthetea.com. Ridding yourself of harmful toxins is truly preventative maintenance. Getthetea.com.
If you're looking for work, you know the math. There are many more applicants than openings, so you need to stand out, not blend into the blah, blah, blah your interviewer is hearing from your competition. Here's a tip. In your interview, you will be judged more by the questions you ask than the answers you give. Yes, do anticipate the obvious job interview questions and prepare concise, insightful, glass-half-full sounding responses. And you should interview your interviewer. Seem genuinely curious about what will help get results. With money and attention so scarce now, effective communication skills have never been more important. You want to cut through the clutter. For more tips for job job seekers and making all the other conversations you have more productive, hit survivalspeech.com. I'm Holland Cook.
If you want to know the latest about Free Talk Live before we go on the air, all you need to decide is how you want it delivered. It's your choice. Visit news.freetalklive.com. You can get emailed announcements and participate in contests via our email updates list. Plus, we have a Twitter account that you can follow and a Facebook page where you can become a fan. So visit news.freetalklive.com to get news about Free Talk Live as soon as it's announced and the way you want it delivered at news.freetalklive.com. That's news.freetalklive.com.
Radio is the most personal of mediums. I exist right now in your head. If you listen to Free Talk Live regularly, you know me. Free Talk Live is on more than 160 radio stations around the U.S. and has been downloaded on every continent around the world. Hundreds of thousands of listeners with ad packages from $600 a month to $6,000 a month. Imagine what we can do for your business, project, website, or idea. Email me, mark@freetalklive.com.
Do you love Twitter? Make sure you favorite the LRN.FM Twitter account so you can receive our tweets at twitter.lrn.fm. That's twitter.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live, dial toll free and bring up anything you want at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. You can join us online at freetalklive.com. Thankfully, our site has not been taken down by the federal government at this point. But considering that's, you know, something they can do anytime they want to, well, I'm appreciative of the fact that they haven't.
Do you have a mirror onion or an onion mirror?
No, I don't. I don't. We do have the dot bit, though. So if we do get taken down, you can use the Namecoin service, the distributed DNS service that is Namecoin, to access our sites. So
assuming that the server doesn't get taken down.
That's a good point. Which in which case we could just put another server up somewhere else. But at this point, they haven't targeted people for speaking out, but what they have done is targeted websites where drugs are being sold. Even though the operators of the sites themselves aren't usually the ones selling the drugs, just the fact that they are purportedly aware that drugs are being sold on those sites is enough for them to be taken out. And so we can tell you more about this deep net or dark net web crackdown or the deep web crackdown that's been going on. 17 people arrested, according to the federal government and the Europol as well. And they claim to have seized over 400.onion domain names from the secretive Tor anonymizing service. Our toll-free number here tonight is 855-450-FREE. And with you in the studio, you've got Ian here.
Ellen.
And Daryl.
Ellen, it's your last night on the show here on Free Talk Live.
No.
And it has been wonderful having you on with us for several months now. I don't know
yes,
how long it's
well,
been. It's been a
it's
while.
Been a wonderful experience, and I appreciate every moment of it.
But you don't get a regular paycheck here, and you actually have a job that is now expanding to include Friday nights. So you will sadly have to leave our airwaves. But that won't be the last that listeners can hear of you. You told me off the air that every now and then you appear on Puke in the Gang.
Once in a while. I wouldn't count on it as a regular thing, but yes, that's as far as I know, that's the only media that I'll be on right now.
Well, obviously, we would love to have you back doing a regular thing in whatever form, so hopefully that will happen someday, and I'm sure you'll let us know.
Yeah, I hope so. I guess I just have to work that out and, you know, get up the motivation to do something like that, because it does take a lot of work. It's not like you just happen to have a radio show one day.
Yeah, nope.
Yeah, it takes a lot of commitment and a lot of planning, and I will let you guys know if I ever do start something.
Could there be a resurrection of ALP?
ALP, which was her show with Allie Havens?
Yes, that was very fun, and I've always wanted to resurrect that, but as far as I can see, that's long gone and may never come back.
Yeah, not everything
what about
comes
ELP?
Back.
Ellen's Liberty Podcast.
Ooh.
Well,
you never know.
That could be a potential. We'll see.
So we'll keep our ears open for you, Ellen. And of course, like I said, it's been great having you on Free Talk Live.
Yeah, well, thank you. It's been great being here every night, and you know, I wouldn't take back a moment of it.
So our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. We've been talking about the crackdown, the global crackdown. By the way, one of our producers, Syphase, sent me an interesting link, which has a list as of August of 2014,
which are the most popular underground websites. And the way they're determining this is the total number of items listed on one of these black market sites.
Okay.
Interestingly, Silk Road 2.0 was number two on this list. It was a close one and two, but
sheep?
No. Sheep Marketplace has been gone for quite a while. They actually ripped off their customers. Sheep Marketplace was one of the startups that happened in the dust of Silk Road 1.0, and it was taken down last year. And a lot of people were very concerned with these startups, saying, well, these guys don't have any credibility. Who the hell are they? I mean, Sheep Marketplace? How do we know they're not going to take people's money from them? Well, some people obviously were willing to risk it because they want to buy drugs. And
right.
So they went on the Sheep Marketplace and they put their money in. And, you know, for a while they were able to get drugs out of it. So it looked like it was good. It looked like it was working. And then, poof, the operators of the site took $100 million worth of Bitcoin from people. So, yeah, no more Sheep Marketplace. So as of August 2014, the number one drug darknet commerce site is Agro Marketplace.
Really?
Yeah.
Wow.
Now, Silk Road right behind them. I mean, Silk Road was a very, very close second. There's a site called Evolution, which was in third place. And according to the list of sites they have taken down, Evolution was not on that list. I've never visited the Evolution site, so presumably it's still online. Pandora, that was on the takedown list. Blue Sky, Andromeda was one of the top ones, and then they get smaller from there.
So I wonder if, since Pandora was, or no, Evolution was the third largest business that was not mm-hmm. taken down, do you think maybe they sold out some of the other sites? They were like, hey, I've got
it.
A tip.
I don't think they know.
I know that this probably, like, most likely did not happen, but I'm just thinking, like, if we put on our tinfoil hats for a moment. And
well, in the real yeah. drug war, in the real life one, yeah. that stuff happens all the time.
That's what I'm thinking. Like, if this was a real scenario where there was, like, drug kingpins fighting over business, then maybe they'd take out their competitors.
Well, if you mentioned sure. Kingpin, and that's actually one of the charges that Ross Ulbricht is facing.
It's true.
Is that Kingpin charge. I don't think that Blake Benthal has the Kingpin charge.
He doesn't, at least not yet. That doesn't mean they can't add that later on. So back to the Wired.com story here about the crackdown, talking about how it's still not known how the feds have identified where these sites are. Now, there has been some suggestion that one of the sites was, or one of the hosts was hosting multiple sites, and that's how they grabbed so many different onions that they've taken down. But still, it's not known how they did it. And when asked how Operation Onimus located the sites, Europol's spokesperson was unapologetically secretive. He said, quote, "This is something we want to keep for ourselves. The way we do this, we can't share with the whole world because we want to do it again and again and again," unquote. The organization that created and maintains Tor, the nonprofit Tor project, said it didn't have any more information on Operation Onimus' techniques, but it downplayed the threat of a vulnerability in Tor's safeguards for the tough-to-trace sites it protects known as Tor Hidden Services. Their spokesman said, quote, "It sounds like old-fashioned police work continues to be effective. It could be that law enforcement targeted common people or organizations running these hidden services, or a hosting company, or something more mundane than a hidden service exploit." And we do know that with Silk Road 2.0, they did have an undercover agent in the operation of the site from the very beginning, which led them to be able to gather a lot of evidence that they otherwise wouldn't have been able to gather. Despite whatever tricks Europol and its American counterparts used to unmask the sites, several of the most popular dark web drug markets have nonetheless eluded them. A study by the nonprofit Digital Citizens Alliance in September found that the six most popular Tor-based markets by total product listings were Silk Road 2, Agora, Evolution, Pandora, Andromeda, and Blue Sky. Operation Onimus captured fully half of those top sites, but Agora, Evolution, and Andromeda remain online and will likely absorb many of the refugee buyers and sellers from the law enforcement bus. In fact, Agora had already passed the Silk Road in total product listings with more than 16,000 mostly illegal offerings, and the fast-growing marketplace Evolution was already on pace to soon take the second-place spot in the underground economy. I mean, at this point, there's a good chance somebody's going to launch a site and put the Silk Road logo on it and call it Silk Road 3.0, but I think that it's not going to be as effective as it was previously.
And I think at this point, with so many of these websites being taken down, it's really just survival of the fittest. So whoever's the smartest at running their site is the one that's going to stay alive the longest and make the most profit.
Man, it's got to be a scary thing to whoever it is that's in charge of Agora Marketplace, which is the number one site right
They're
now.
They're loosening their tie a little bit as they read this.
You know it. I mean, that's got to be really nerve-wracking. I would recommend, if you're listening, Agora Marketplace operator to Free Talk Live, please don't live in the United States. If you live in the United States, as has Blake Benthal and Ross Ulbricht.
They were both in the same city.
In San Francisco, yeah. If you do live in the United States, please start making a plan to move as quickly as possible. Now, I don't think that's going to necessarily keep you safe, because as they've said here, there have been over a dozen countries involved in these 17 arrests, and you know, they law enforcement does tend to cooperate on these matters globally.
Of course they do.
All right, but if, as John Grisham says, you cannot be found in South America, so just
John Grisham has said that. Is that I don't know if it's true.
Well, in most of his novels, the heroes will escape to South America.
Well, there have to be places where you're safer, right? I mean, there have to be places where the cops are just like, ah, whatever.
Inside the Ecuadorian embassy in London.
That's pretty safe, at least for Julian Assange. So Operation Onimus comes just after a year, about a year after the takedown of the original Silk Road drug site and the arrest of its alleged creator, Ross Ulbricht. In an open letter to Attorney General Eric Holder last week, New York Senator Charles Schumer called for a renewed crackdown on the flourishing dark web sites that have filled the void left by the original Silk Road. And that appears to be exactly what is happening. Their spokesperson in Europol says, "This is just the beginning of our work. We will hunt these sites down all the time now. We've proven we can work together, and we're a well-oiled machine. It won't be a risk-free run to run services like this anymore." We are out of time for tonight, but we'll be back tomorrow. Join us online in the meantime at freetalklive.com and Daryl's site, fpp.cc.
Free Talk Live.
Some old codger Republican is screaming at his radio.
This is not a democracy.
Yeah, it's
we live in a democracy. We live in a republic.
And to that guy, take a deep breath. Tell me the operative difference between a democracy and a republic.
Well, we elect representatives in a republic.
That's true.
And you respect rights.
A direct democracy certainly is a democracy where everybody gets a vote. But tell me about this respecting rights thing. What other republic, in fact, respects rights?
The People's Republic of China.
Right. So this idea that we live in a republic is really just fallacious. It's just some term that someone's come up with. In Greek, democracy means of the people. Republic in Latin means for the people or something.
Don't forget the Democratic People's Republic of Korea.
That's right.
A republic.
Right. There's another republic. I mean, republics are all over. Take a pill. Republic means nothing.
Free Talk Live, 7 nights a week from 7 to 10 Eastern, live on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
When I found the Free State Project, I knew it was the key to achieving liberty in my lifetime. It's awesome to be surrounded by like-minded, freedom-loving activists who've moved here to New Hampshire. From politics to civil disobedience, we have it all. Where I came from, it felt that no matter what I did, liberty was dying. Perhaps you feel the same way? Call 888-377-2515 now to learn more about the Free State Project. That's 888-377-2515 or visit freestateproject.org.
Here's a chance to do a little activism while you're cruising Facebook, Twitter, or Google+. Between the LOL cats, the recipes, the hot girls, and the inspirational sunrise memes, Free Talk Live's posts pass by your newsfeed. Like them. Comment. It gives us more exposure. If you don't see our posts, click like at facebook.freetalklive.com and then hover over it to click get notifications. It's an easy way to spread the ideas of liberty a bit further. I know you're busy, but you can spare that tenth of a calorie it takes to click on something. Facebook.freetalklive.com.
The Corey Moore Show is coming up next, live after the news, here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
This is the Liberty Beat, your daily source for Liberty news and activist updates, online at thelibertybeat.com. I'm Brian Hagan with your Liberty Beat for Thursday, November 6, 2014. Gold is trading around $1,144, silver $15.39, and Bitcoin is trading around $338. Today's Bitcoin price brought to you by ExpressCoin, the fastest and most reliable way to buy Bitcoin. Buy Bitcoin today at ExpressCoin.com. Today's edition of the Liberty Beat brought to you by our newest sponsor, eFoods Direct. redefining the way you think about storable food. Easy to make and great tasting, with a shelf life of over 25 years. To celebrate our new partnership, eFoods Direct is offering Liberty Beat listeners 10% off their purchases. To take advantage of this exciting offer, call 800-620-5520 and mention coupon code LibertyBeat. To learn more or to buy online, visit eFoodsDirect.com. In the news, on Wednesday, thousands of protesters around the world took part in the Million Mask March, with demonstrators in Washington, D.C. and London challenging the police head-on. London police arrested 10 people after protesters clashed with police officers and allegedly committed assault. At one point, the protesters grabbed metal barriers, which separated police from the activists. In Washington, D.C., protesters also wrestled with police over metal barriers. The mass protesters in the nation's capital verbally challenged the police and called for an end to government corruption. The BBC reports Egypt's policies toward protesting citizens are under review by the Human Rights Council of the U.S.-funded United Nations. Since 2011, revolution has rocked Egypt and caused major upheaval following the ouster of longtime president Hosni Mubarak. After democratically elected Mohamed Morsi was removed by a military coup last year, military ruler President Assisi has been heavily criticized by U.S. and European nations for perpetrating violence against innocent protesters exercising political speech. However, the United States continues to work with Assisi. As during the reign of Mubarak, the United States sends Egypt roughly $3 billion in foreign aid each year. Over 2,000 people have died in the conflict in Egypt. On Tuesday, Hawaiian voters decided to ban the growing of genetically modified crops. The new measure creates a temporary moratorium on GM crops until further health and environmental studies are completed. Support for the Liberty Beat comes from Central Texas Gunworks, your online source for firearms, firearm accessories, and ammunition. They take major credit cards and now accept Bitcoin. Visit them online at shop.centraltexasgunworks.com. Support also comes from Marjorie Wildcraft's Grow Your Own Groceries. Homegrown food on every table. That's growyourowngroceries.org. This is the Liberty Beat for Thursday, November 6th, 2014. Check out the website at thelibertybeat.com and like us on Facebook at facebook.com/thelibertybeat. On Wednesday, President Barack Obama said he would work with Congress on new war powers to fight Islamic State militants and expressed cautious optimism about whether the international face-off over Iran's nuclear program will be resolved. Two issues that could prove harder for the White House to maneuver with Republicans in charge on Capitol Hill. The Associated Press reports that Obama spoke at a news conference the day after his party was thrashed by Republicans in elections, leaving the Republicans soon to be in charge of both the House and the Senate. Obama's decision will test the ability of the divided Congress to agree on a war strategy for Iraq and Syria. A St. Louis circuit judge has ruled Missouri's ban on same-sex marriages as unconstitutional. Judge Rex Burleson called the freedom to marry a fundamental right deeply rooted in the history of the United States. The news comes a day after a federal judge ruled a similar ban in Kansas was in violation of the Constitution. On Monday, a district judge threw out an alleged 1993 confession from Daniel Villegas, the Texas man who spent 19 years behind bars for a murder he did not commit. The district judge stated that the